What a lovely shot that is. Sure. And it's goal.
Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League.
We're back at Pallekele for match 15 of the Mahindra Sri Lanka Premier League. It's the Uthura Rudras versus the Basnahira Cricket Dundees. Well, the crowd's been gathering. The evenings are much cooler. It's much more comfortable for spectators as well as the players out there. Well, Dean Jones was out there with the toss.
Hello everyone and welcome to the toss of the Uthura Rudras and Basnahira, and we've got the two captains, one very sick, the other one okay. We've got the match referee and of course the Pepsi mascot. Thank you very much. Dilsh, you've got the coin call? Heads is the call.
And it's there's Nishan.
We are going to bet.
You're going to have a bet?
Yeah.
Any reason?
I think it's this youth wicket. We are playing four spinners today. Mm-hmm. Special, we bring Mohamedullah as spinner.
Yeah.
I think we can put some runs in the board. We see last few matches chasing is very difficult, in especially slow wicket.
You're not worried about the dew factor a little bit later on?
Not that bad. The thing is, both teams, yesterday also I saw it's Sanat also bowling really well in the spinning wicket. This is a youth wicket. We have to take the advantage for that. We can't depend on the dew.
And you have to win the next couple of games or you're out of it?
Yeah, definitely. But this is an important match today. We have to finish strong today, and we look forward to next match after that. Everyone putting ahead for this match today.
All right, mate. I'll let you go. I know you're not feeling that well. Good on you. Thanks very much. Jayhan, what would you have done?
We've not quite decided, as actually, to be honest.
What would you have done?
We would have bowled first. Okay. The dew factor played on our minds, so we felt it would have been easier chasing, ball coming on a bit more, and hopefully with a bit of grip on the surface, we'd be able to take the pace off the ball when we bowl first.
Got to win your first six overs. You got opportunities and just haven't done it.
Exactly. We've been, especially in the last game, I thought we played, pretty much to our potential, but mistakes at the beginning in the first six overs and towards the end cost us the game.
You've had four losses. Are you trying anything different? Are you changing your batting order?
Just a few changes in the batting order. Maybe we might have Roshan opening, and maybe just a couple of things. But I mean, changing batting order is not going to make much of a difference. It's just changing our approach and how we play the game.
Well, I hope you get a win. Thanks very much.
Yes, thanks.
Well, there you have it. Basnahira won the toss and they elected to bat.
And didn't Dino confuse the captains? There we have the teams for today. The Rudras going in with the same team that played the game before. But the Basnahira Cricket Dundee is making a few changes. Langefeld's out. Dirk Nanas is out. And comes back into the team is Dan Smith. He'll be keeping wickets. As well as Mohamedullah. Well, they got a fire. These are the young boys that Sri Lanka have pinned their hopes on. Jayan Mubarak and Charman Kapukedera were picked as potential players a few years ago, yet not delivered quite up to expectations. Brendan Taylor from Zimbabwe, another young batsman who can hit that ball hard. The customary huddle, Tomo.
Yeah, the huddle, I don't know what they say here. Just back yourselves and get out there and help one another out. I mean, they all would have said this before they gone out there. And there's that familiar burly figure of Dan Smith. He's been given a reprieve. He was arrested the other night and didn't quite work. And now he's back on deck again.
And opening the batting too. He opened twice, was dismissed on both occasions off the fourth ball for Ducks. Came in at number three, got himself off the mark, but yet didn't really go to impress. A very hard-hitting opening batsman, Dan Smith. He needs to fire if the Basnahira Cricket Dundees are to put up a good score on the board.
Well, it's as we said, the top order have to, the batters up there, somebody in the top five or six has to do the work. to set these innings up. And well, as we've seen of a night time, usually the pitch does a little bit more with the newer ball first up. And who have we got to test that out? Smith has had a lot of trouble hitting the ball, let alone when it's moving around.
He'd like to have a much better strike rate, Dan Smith. That's his reputation. But he's been consistent, Tilakratna Dilshan, at the non-striker's end. Very experienced international player. Loves playing the dill scoop.
And Dupree will open the attack.
Well, you were talking about the ball doing a lot. Yesterday, it did a lot off the bat, Tomo.
Last evening? Yeah, well, the reason being, one of your countrymen was bashing everybody everywhere. But it generally does. I mean, when he first came in, he was struggling a bit. He miscued a few. He had a little bit of luck to start with. That new ball's got to do some damage.
But the key was, Tamim Iqbal and Jayawardhan up the order did identify that that would happen. They did identify they needed to ride that period and quietly put the pressure on the bowlers. They're up again.
Well, it was a big noise. Maybe it clipped his shirt. Obviously, the umpire thinks that, but it was a big shout by at least four or five of the fielding side, the Rudras.
They went up straight away, and it was a shorthand jab. Oh, one of those love handles, probably.
Nah, it's just off his waist, isn't it?
He's off the mark with a commanding drive. Dan Smith on his way.
Well, he's not completely on his way, but that'll do a fair bit of confidence boosting for it.
Pitch right up, looking for that swing. Not finding any. But Dan Smith finding the swing of the bat.
He uses a lot of bottom hand on that shot, doesn't he, Smith? Look at it here. You can see the way it's loaded. Bang.
That came back in.
Where did that go? It didn't bounce much, but boy, did it seem to curve from my position here. The wicketkeeper did a good job to stop that one. Let's have a look.
Yeah, Jack back in. Brendan Taylor. He's going the wrong way. And also taking the ball on the volley is never easy.
Not a good one to leave, was it? Well, it was in the end because it missed the stumps, but ooh, his heart would have been in his mouth.
Much quicker from Dupree hitting the bat high.
He goes at him one pace, doesn't he, Smith? He just lashes at him.
You need to pace your innings well. Yesterday, Jayawardhan did very well. In the last five overs, the Wymer United put on 74 runs. 53 of that to Jayawardhan. So he set the foundation up and then go for it. First over once again, Dan Smith. This time it's Timber.
Well, unfortunately, that was the last ball of the over, and it was one too many for Dan Smith. I was just commenting on how he goes hard at the ball. Dupree, well, it's another in-swinger, isn't it? Just ducked back nicely, went through the gate, and a pretty happy bowler there. Not too happy on the batsman's face. Dan Smith's gone for that 1-4, and it's one wicket down.
Riley Russo, the new batsman in. He looked pretty competent the other day, very good, well organized. And look at that strike rate, 130. Dilshan's on strike though. Dattopiris, the under 21 player in the Uthura Rudras team, opening the bowling from the Hunnasgiriya end.
Yeah, he's another one of our young guns on display here in the tournament.
But this was good bowling. He bowled the outswinger and then he realized that Dan Smith was not reading the ball at all. Then started bowling the in-duckers.
Well, surely Smith should look at the bowling style. He should have seen that that was an in-ducker shape when the way the bowler shaped up for that. You know, you look for certain trigger things, don't you, as a batsman? You should do anyway. You do as a bowler, you know. And the guy opens his chest, he's pulling his hand down that way. It's going to be nothing else but an in-swinger.
He's had a horror time, so what he's thought of doing is, come out there, if it's in my zone, I'm going after it. And he got one through the covers. Way down the leg side from Piris.
Yeah, we see another extra. There's plenty of extras being throughout this tournament, especially up here at night time. The ball is zinging around.
Well, the Uthura Rudras know all about it, though. The ball moving around. Their last game against the Uwa next. The first four overs ended up being maidens, and they also lost two wickets.
Oh, they were the culprits. Yeah, that's right.
It would have been three. Mubarak was dropped in the slips, and that was the first run that the Rudras got it. It's taken the slip off because Chattopadhyay is angling the ball into the left-hander. In the gap. For a moment I thought it was hit straight at mid-wicket, and Russo's on his way with the boundary.
Yeah, so I was thinking the same myself. I thought, gee, that was a good captaincy move there. But he picked the gap there. It was there to hit. He hits it uppishly, but he always had picked the gap between those two fielders there. You'll get a better idea there.
They're committing himself onto the front foot. There's plenty of time for him to adjust. Deep square leg goes down, short fine leg in the circle. Oh, well bowled, went the other way. Russo giving him the charge.
Well, he did, didn't he? Russo went walkabout on this one, come down the pitch to him. But Pires was good enough to adjust. And just a little outswing there too.
Geez, it's nice to watch, isn't it, when the ball just jags around a bit. Can't find the gaps, but finds the middle of the bat again, Russo.
I think this is a really good cricket pitch, Russell. I don't know what you think yourself, but I mean, we see bowlers get wickets if you're good enough. You see spinners get it. You see pace bowlers with a little bit of a tease with a new ball. It lasts for about half a dozen overs where it swings, and then the batting can take over. So if you're good enough in all departments, batting, bowling and spin, you're going to get results.
Straight to the fielder, direct hit will have him in trouble, but Imran Farhat misses. Well, we'll come back to that point as it's the end of the second over. It's 11 for 1. Table once again, it's the bottom of the table clash, but a couple of wins here for either team can actually change that around.
Yeah, we saw Eva, that was this last delivery, the run out chance, Imran Farah took his time to line this up. It was a one-stump view, and he didn't really go close to it. He took a, give it a good lineup, had to hit and missed.
Well, this is a better single. He hit it into the gap, whereas the one before, he hit it straight to Farhat and took off. Well, I'm with you on the pitch, Tomo. It gives everyone a chance, a spinner, a fast ball, and even a batsman. And it is a bit tactical. You can't just come out there and bash. You have to work yourself into a position from where you can take control as a batsman. So if you're good enough, as you say, there are rewards out here.
Yeah, it brings in all the traits. You've got to show a little bit of patience, a little bit of respect for the pace bowlers. It moves around a bit. So if you're good enough to play the swing, good. You stay in there, you're going to get runs, a la Mahela last night. And if you're good enough, and then, as I said before, spinners have got a chance. Everybody's got a chance.
You've got to throw in the calculated risk too. Goes hard, Dilshan, feet nowhere. But Dupri, he's enjoying that in Dhaka.
I think he's enjoying just bowling with his new ball. This is Dan Smith in the first over. Nelly got a touch on that hook shot, got the four away. Oh, and then Nelly got bowled with that one. Got that one away, and then did get bowled eventually. There wasn't a great deal of foot movement there from Smith with the ball moving around.
He sees it there, he goes after it, Dilshan. You get nothing different from him.
Well, he's given him the in-swinger, and then this one was the out-swinger. So this is what we're talking about, the ball just moving around. Goes a fair bit, that one, doesn't it? He would have done well to nick that.
Yeah, there's a slip in place. And also, as you would always see, the fielder square of the wicket. I mean, square of the wicket is heavily populated. You don't find a regulation extra cover. Wow, that was good to watch. Didn't try to hit too hard, Dilshan. Carved it through the little gap that he saw on the offside.
Yes, he really played this well. Really punches it through cover point area. And it was an easy shot. There's a loaded field out there. There was the attempt. And there is the slow-mo of the shot. Beautiful execution.
Balled early. Bill Russo's running for everything. He's quick between the wickets too. Just what you need to be doing.
Well, Dean Jones would be happy with that, the way they run between the wickets there. Was the batsman got in the way of the throw that was going to his end, and consequently got struck by the ball, but was going to stop any chance of a run out.
That's Dilshan's Mahindra SLPL, 172 runs, 250s to his name.
Just runs that one off the face. Boundary, singles, that's the way to do it. And 18 for one after three.
Slow start once again for the Basnahira cricket Dundees. They've lost their opener, Dan Smith. New bowler being brought in. Madhushanka Ekanayaka, the new bowler. Bowled very well in the last game that he played against who were next. Quite sharp he is.
Yeah, not too bad of stats there. He's only just got the one wicket, but he hasn't gone particularly expensive. He gets the opportunity with a new ball here where it's going to do something, you would think, might help him out.
Oh, he's good to watch, this boy, Riley Russo. Very stylish. And here are the highest scorers in the Mahindra SLPL. Kamran Akmal leading the way with 191. He's played just the 4 innings. Dilshan is, of course, playing his 5th inning. Myla Jayawardhan, 116 at the bottom of this particular list. But, of course, a wonderful 96 last night from him. Top shot. That'll be 4. Just ease that through. The way he opened the face of the bat to pick that gap was the key.
Yeah, he just walked around it a little, didn't he, to give himself some room. You'll see him start to move now. Opens up. He's still got to place it. And that's exactly what he did execute pretty well.
Way. Now, Wyambo United are leading the points table. They're unbeaten. In a quick single, he'll make it easy.
Oh, I don't know so much about easy. He had to really get on his motorbike there to get in. Throw was on. It was to his good a hand. Well, it would have been pretty even Stevens, that one.
And there's a reason why Wyambo United are dominating. Look at this list once again. Kamran Akmal, Wyambo United. Tamim Iqbal, Wyambo United. Mahela Jayawardhan, Wyambo United. Top 5, out of the top 5 run scorers, they've got 3 up there.
That's exactly right.
Wild swing from Tilakratna Dilshan. That's not the way to go. Good cricket shots. As you see, Russo play, giving you more results than these big moves.
That was a little in-swinger as well. He was counting, I think, for an out-swinger there, and it just ducked back in and up, and that was enough for it to miss the bat. He's definitely in an aggressive mood. Dilshan out there.
Yeah, that's his zone, outside the off-stump. He will go hard. He's got one through the field. That was a good cricketing shot. In the air. It would just be the single. Still struggling to find his timing.
Yeah, he tried, almost stopped that shot, didn't he? He went to go at it hard and then pulled out of it. And in the end, chipped the ball in the air.
The way he sets up, the ball that nips back in can get him into trouble. He's looking to hit that ball hard through the covers. More often, you do find a gap between bat and pad. Edge for 4. That's the way to do it. Riley Russo, end of 4, it's 28 for 1.
Well, there we go. We just had a go at the leading run scorers. Now we've got the leading wicket takers, and Tanveer, he's bowled beautifully on top. But again, look down the bottom 2, 7 and 7, Wyambo United. So they got up there with the batting, and they're up there with the bowling, and that's why they're on top, as we said before. And one of them could be also walking away with one of these cars. The Mahindra XUV. It's the man of the match prize, and obviously a few of those stats we just showed you would be the leading runners for that car to win it, take it away at the end of this series, the Mahindra XUV 500, and that's for the man of the series, judged from the man of the matches.
The crowd has definitely built up right throughout the evening.
That's if I bring it back, because we're taking it to Colombo tomorrow for a test drive. So as long as Dean Jones doesn't drive it, it should be in good nick.
That's the one he ordered, the red one. Leg by. They're quietly getting a move on, Basnahira cricket Dundee's, but Dilshan needs to realize that he has to dig in. He has to make sure that he bats at least to the 12th or the 15th over. Just keep knocking it around. We are in the 5th over. Let's look at this. The 12th over, that's 7 overs from here. At 7 runs and over, you're close to 90. With wickets in hand, you're well set to put pressure on the bowlers.
Well, who's your betting on out of these two this game? Who do you think should get it? Just before the game even started, who do you think were favourites?
Well, for me, Basnahira cricket Dundee's. Get to the 12th over and then look to launch. There comes your 150, 160, and enough to put the pressure on the Uthura Rudras.
I tend to agree with you there, just looking through the team sheets and that. I think they're a little stronger in the batting.
It's not about panicking. It's about accumulating at this stage and setting it up for your team. It's a long while. 20 overs, we might say, is a short time, but that's 120 balls. A lot can happen.
Yeah, no, that's right. You think initially, oh, we haven't got much time. You've got to, you know, just hurry up. But in the end, it does take a little bit, as we've seen. A bit of patience, and it's surprising how quick you can get a good score up.
And as you'd expect, with more T20 cricket being played, even the game, to some extent, has become much more tactical than when it started. Two runs off the five ball so far, Tilakratna Dilshan. When he's going at his best, when he's at his best, very good at dropping that ball and running. What we see from him today is get that foot out and swing at the ball. That's all he's doing.
Well, these are the power overs, but too, he's trying to cash in on the field up, I suppose, more than anything, for these first six overs.
More like that, keep the gaps, keep the strike rotating. At the end of five, it's 30 for one. Will continue in the commentary box for the next five overs. Roshan Abe single with Dean Jones.
Thank you, Russell. Well, 30 for one. Basnahira Dundee. They'll have to move on quite quickly from here. They need a decent score on the board. They need to get back to winning ways. Uthura Rudras haven't won anything so far. And Ekanayaka will bowl the sixth over with Russo, the batsman, on strike. He's looked good, really, Russo. He's hit 3 fours of just 12 balls.
Quick single there. The Rudras for me just haven't played well in the first six overs. Today they've been okay. I'd like to get another wicket, but this is probably their best ever six overs effort in the whole competition, with the ball or with the bat. So they've tried to do a few different things here and trying to get momentum back, and you know, they've trained really hard. I think I heard Tom Moody said the boys have just kept working hard. Some things just doesn't happen. You don't get wins early, you're gone. Oh, amazing. Just amazing.
That's a shot of his own. There is no doubt. He's made it his own shot, his invention. That's why it's called the Dill Scoop. and just can't believe how he could really set himself up to play that shot. But just look at this. I mean, it off the middle of the bat, it went so far.
Kids, do not try this at home. You will get killed. Please do not try this at home, only with the tennis ball. Imagine the first time he tried it. It's courage, I tell you.
Well, I did do an interview with him and he did explain where he started. And I believe it happened in the IPL.
I thought he tried it somewhere else before that. Or maybe I just saw it somewhere else, maybe.
It was IPL and he said every time he tried, the wicketkeeper was Gilchrist. And when he missed a few of those, Gilchrist was getting a bit worried. And then when he connected one, he heard, or at least he saw the frustration on Gilchrist's face. So he felt it was an effective shot.
Did he try it in the net first?
Yeah, of course he did.
Paulding! Maybe should have done it again. But he's been a champ and we love him. But he's been knocked over here and that's the big wicket.
Well, they wanted it and they have it. They've had it. The Rudras. They've got Tilakratna Dilshan. Madhusan Kekanayake, the young man, he's struck gold. So Tilakratna Dilshan, the batsman, dismissed. Bowled by Kanayake. He's gone for 14. Basnahira Dundee's 37 for 2.
Two wickets have fallen the first six overs for the Rudras, and that's the reason why here. Just missed a straight one, took his eyes off it. He's not feeling that well. And Peg was in the air, and the death rattle there. That's the big wicket. A big wicket indeed. Look at this castle right into that. That's what you got to do in this level of game. If they miss, you've got to hit the stumps. So, Ekanayake, well done to him. It's always nice to knock over icons. And now, who comes from South Australia, strike rate of 122.3, got a 62 not out, hasn't really hurt too many people up to now, but he's a very good player, trust me.
Ekanayake has been good, he's been on target, very, very accurate. That last delivery was a good first ball to Bogus. He's gone for a few. He's gone at 9.27 because he's gone for 7 in his over, including that deal scope 6. But those dot balls, balls in between have been good. Been impressive for somebody as young as he is.
Good bowling, ramps it down to third man. Should only be one. Ends the over. Got a wicket, 8 runs from it. 38 for 2.
Well, we're back with these killer denim contenders. Shaminde Ranga, Akila Dhananjaya and Chaturanga Kumara. Akila Dhananjaya has been the one who's really created the impression, because he hasn't really, he wasn't known outside his school when he started playing in this. He's come in here and bowled some great spells. And of course Chaturanga Kumara has had his moments, and so did Shaminde Ranga. Ranga, let's not forget, has played for Sri Lanka, so he's having a bit of experience as a bowler, but the other two are pretty new.
Gunaratne coming on, the experienced one. Look at those figures. Outstanding at this level, 6.65, the economy rate. Gets one there. It's a good award by the killer denim. I noticed Jeff Thompson wearing some killer denims today. They're supposed to be for the young kids, aren't they? Or supposed he's a young kid at heart. Tomo, still super fit, still looking good. Right now, Russell got 17 from 13 balls. Need to be looking for 150, 155. Oh, it got him. That's got him. It's bowled him. It's definitely bowled him. They're asking now, or has he caught it? Now, something's got... Oh, they could take a quick single. Why not? Go on, take a single. Oh, there's confusion everywhere. Now, let's go through this slowly.
Well, they're asking for the catch. And Jihan Mubarak was... Or was it the ball that they were interested? Well, if the bails didn't come off, they can't be complaining.
It hit the stump ever so slowly. There's a mark there. Oh, I don't know. The mark was already there. Yeah, I did hear a sound. Big one on the leg side.
That's strange, wasn't it? Very strange. I certainly thought they were pretty confident about the court behind. That's what they were all appealing for. Well, umpire Vijayawardhan had none of it.
Oh, the first went away there, tries to anticipate the ball's going to be reverse swept. Interesting thing for me when I interviewed Dilshan at the toss, Roshan, was the fact that I asked him, what about the dew factor later on? And he looked at me as if, dew coming, does it? He's been watching us every night. He would have known there's a dew factor. Ball gets nice and wet, hard to bowl. So he's... 8 runs and over for me, 150, is that enough? Oh, there's the little reverse paddle. Geez, they're good at this stuff. Oh, gee, look a full when you get out, but that's a good four.
So much of innovation, so much of improvisation at this level with T20 cricket. We've just seen a deal scoop for 6. And now this one, Augus, he's playing it so well. Wake and slip. And used the pace of the ball and ran it down.
Another example why the keeper does not wear, should always be wearing a helmet. That reverse sweep could have gone straight in the face of Brendan Taylor. It doesn't wear a mouth guard. And I tell you, dental surgery is quite expensive. Looking for 2, running the first one hard. So that's a better over there. But Basnahira, 9 runs from it. It's 47 for 2. Basnahira, who 47 for 2 here, 8 runs and over from now on. They'll get 151. That might be enough. Might be okay. Now just watch this. Just watch the reverse paddle and how close it is to his head. He's getting it close. Oh, and that's just missed his jaw. But for all the kids, whoever wicket keep, I just believe they must wear a helmet. And he's not wearing a mouth guard or anything like that. That's quite dangerous. I know he mightn't like it, but I tell you what, you want your teeth. There's the call. Brendan Taylor from Zimbabwe.
Oh,
August, who's got 8 from 7 balls faced. He's got a boundary already, but now they're looking to try in the next 3 overs to get it over 65 runs, up to 70 runs after 10 overs at the halfway mark. No, a quick call. Very good call indeed. That's what you want from the batsman on strike.
Yes, very quick call indeed. They can't afford run outs at this stage. They need a partnership going, Basnahira Dundee. They won the first game, but then have lost almost everything else.
Quick call here. If he hits, oh, I think he might have been gone. He might have been gone. His bat didn't slide through the crease properly. Oh, Taylor should have hit him.
This is a look at the run out, but he was well in. Taylor had to take his glove off and then underarm it, so that time did allow the batsman to get in quickly. But these direct hits always create the difficult moment for the runner.
Wicketkeepers don't practice that enough for me. I know they do a lot of nicky practice, but they don't do enough of that for me. In the air, pick the bones out of that.
Oh, sweet sound of leather on willow. Ekanayaka was hit on the up. Russo just coming down the pitch. That was huge. That was banged in just short. He was down the pitch. And look at the distance, 90 meters.
Good replay, doesn't overhit, does he? In control, keeps his shape, big use of the hips, and the arms follow. Oh, that's a good smash. Now that's worried the living daylights out of them. Let me tell you, Ekanayaka, he's gone for 25 from his 2.4 overs. Just feeling a little bit hesitant bowling to this guy.
Excellent comeback by Madhusanka Ekanayaka after being hit for a 6. He bowls in swingers to the right-hander, takes it away from the left-hander. And after that 6, look at that seam position. Good seam position. Tight line around midland leg. Didn't give him the room. That kept Russo quiet.
That ends the over, 8 runs from it, 55 for 2. Two, 8 runs and over from here. They'll get 151. Basnahira cricket at Dundee. And they're playing tonight. Only got one more game left there again on the 25th in Colombo at Premadasa against the Royals there. They need to win every game here to make the finals. Oh, that must be out. No, I heard another sound. Am I hearing things?
Well, you certainly seem to be, Dino. The umpire hasn't heard. That's what matters.
Well, Jeffrey Dujon was commenting in the back of the box. I hear things regularly. You're right, the middle of the night. Taylor went up straight away. Oh, inside edge. Bowling well, isn't he?
He's clever, Gunaratna. He mixes it up. Uses the pace of the ball well. Doesn't spin the ball too much. A good loop he's got. And generally can be pretty deceptive off the pitch. And Russo struggled with the pace of the ball, was looking to really hit it through mid-off.
A looking for two, running the first one hard. Are they going to come back? They are. They're risking a good try. Oh, no, in trouble, maybe. I thought he made it. We're not going to go to the third umpire. Great running, boys. Fantastic stuff.
Well, he's not going upstairs, so obviously he's run well. But a direct hit can always make it tight. Yeah, he's well in. Excellent running. And yes, good umpiring, because he made his decision without really making it look obvious.
Saves us a bit of time. Going to the third umpire. Again, looking for two. Will they get it again? Good turn again. No, it was a quick call from Bogus there. Imran getting a few touches. So that's one thing I used to do to stop myself from getting bored in one day. Number of times I fielded the ball in a one-day international, my worst was 4, my best was 52 against the West Indies. 4 was against Sri Lanka, believe it or not. End of the over, 4 runs from it, 59 for 2 is the strategic timeout. Basnahira winning the toss, electing to bat, 59 for 2. Russell starting to get going now, 26 from 22, and Bogus 12 from 11.
Well, the temple of the sacred tooth relic is a Buddhist temple in the city of Kandy in Sri Lanka. The temple of the sacred tooth relic constitutes the premier Buddhist institution of Sri Lanka. The Gandakuti is the chamber of the incensed house where the sacred tooth relic has been kept. The tooth shrine itself receives a constant flow of worshippers and flocks of tourists. It is also a great tourist attraction.
Stunning place. I went to that first time in 1994, Roshan, and I never have had the opportunity of getting here this time, but it's an enlightening experience. It really is. Runner Navet hasn't seen a hairdresser for a while. The flying mullet, look at those numbers, 128 wickets from 104 matches. He's got a fifer as well, economy rate fantastic. He knows where to bowl in these games. Come on, a good time too, just when Basnahira wants to put the foot down here. I'm always worried about the first over after a strategic timeout. A lot of wickets tend to fall. Knows the call. I've been impressed by these two for running between the wickets. Good, quick calls.
It's the key in these forms of cricket anyway, 50 over cricket, T20 cricket, demands good running, good understanding, and the short single always and test your fielders inside the 30-yard circle.
Oh, it just ramps it down to third man for one. Lee Fielder, well done, good work. Really good work down there, save two.
Kuipers Dupree, who ran around on the boundary at third man. But look how clever the batsman is. Watch the ball onto the bat and then at the last minute, steered it down to third man.
I think that's the way to play on this pitch. Look how he gets so low there. Wonderful pitches there. What you should do, keep the body behind the ball, keep the ball in front of you. No, quick call again. Don't fight this pitch because it's a little bit inconsistent now, up and down. That's just tendency not to trust the pitch that much. August though, he's got 14 for 14. Nice foundation to put the foot down soon. No doubt they'll be looking for a score of over 150. A need to win this match to stay in the hunt to make the finals. Good bowling again. Good experience stuff from the Pakistani veteran.
Yeah, it's the key for the Basnahira Dundees. They have to win. But as far as the Rudras are concerned, they need to salvage something out of this. They haven't won anything. And, well, they seem to be camera shy, hiding their faces from the cameras, but not these ones. They're enjoying themselves. They've enjoyed the cricket. I can tell you people have seen some excellent cricket here.
Rams the third man, just a single. I love the fact that they run the first one hard, these two, just in case there's a mistake on the boundary. Nearly at the halfway stage of this innings. 62 on the board for two. The owner's there. Basnahira. Pulls it away and very well fielded. Good over it was again. Three runs from it. It's 62 for two. Well, if you walked up to the Basnahira skipper and said, look, Dilshan, would you like to have 145, 150, I think he'd take it. This pitch is getting a little bit harder to hit it around. But anyways, to take you through the next five overs, it's Jeffrey Dujon and Russell Arnold.
Thank you, Dino. Basnahira. They're struggling to really get some serious momentum going. Dean Jones said the pitch is getting a little bit more difficult, but the bowling has been pretty tight here, Russell.
Yeah, they've been spot on. And on the other hand, the options the Basnahira Cricket Dundee batsmen have taken haven't actually come off. If you do allow bowlers to come in, hit a length on a round off stump, they'll keep doing it time and time again. That's where the calculated risk comes in. You try and put pressure on the bowler and get him to bowl to your zone.
Another quick single. Been getting quite a few of those, but they need some boundaries. Mandy is somewhere around. Where are you?
I'm right here at the dugout of the Uthura Rudras, and with me is Rob Quiney. What's your experience here in Sri Lanka been so far? Many Australians come to this part of the world and fall in love with it.
Apart from obviously the results haven't gone our way, but it's been fantastic. I've been here Colombo once before, and come to Kandy first time. It's been a great experience. You know, obviously the crowd's been great, turning out and nice and noisy.
I believe you had a great game of golf yesterday with Jehan Mubarak. Tell us a little bit about that.
I wouldn't say great. I shot 104, so I got value for money, that's for sure. But no, it was a good day. It's beautiful weather, and the Victoria Golf Course out there put on a good show, yeah.
And also a happy belated birthday. I believe you had a lovely celebration yesterday away from home. Tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, no, I turned 29 again, luckily enough. So that was a bit of fun, and I think it's a subcontinent tradition for people to get the cake all over their face. So that happened to me last night, unfortunately, but it was all good.
Well, you're lucky there are no breakouts in your face.
Yeah, I've got freckles anyway, so it looks like I've got chocolate on my face in the first place, but that's all good.
Thanks very much for talking to us.
No worries. I've got to say watermelon as well, so thank you very much.
Rob Kwahi, there, what a hell of a celebration yesterday away from home. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Mandy. Mandy's in Kandy, Dooch. She's here to buy a bottle of brandy.
Well, I can see that. I can see, Russell, that even though you're not feeling 100% today, it hasn't really affected your sense of humor. Speaking of birthdays, one of our BT technicians, Russ Grubbelaar, is celebrating his birthday today. So happy birthday, Joss. Flicked away. There we go. Four more. You're talking about innovation and there you see some right there, Russell.
Well, you want a boundary? This is the shot. They've tried the extra cover drive, they've tried square cuts, they've tried all sorts of shots. But the Dill Scoop went for six, and now Bogus getting four.
Well, when the conventional doesn't work, gotta try something else. Score goes up to 70. I'd have to say that it's pretty even Steven right now. 6.46, not where Basnahira would like to be. That looked fairly close. And I'm sure that Uthura would love to have a couple more wickets in the bag. We've had 11. It's 71 for 2. Rana Navid is going to continue. He's been very miserly, just three runs off his bowling so far.
Yeah, another couple of overs, Dooch, and then look to go after the bowling and try and get 9 to 10 runs. Wickets in hand, always key.
Well, we've actually seen that a score of anywhere around 150 is very defendable. They'll have to be looking in that region. Uthura have done a very good job of restricting them. They'll have to get up to 10 and over to get to 150. And the way the bowling has looked so far, that's going to be a very tall job. Flicked away. They'll pick up another couple.
One over can change things around. One big over. And the batsman will get the feel that they're on top. Once that happens, for the bowlers, it'll be more damage control. There'll be the opportunity to score runs.
Well, the key is that these two are going to have to stick around for a while.
A
longer they're there, is the more easier it will be to score. The more comfortable they'll be taking chances. Partnership 37 now from 36 balls. Say a couple of boundaries, a couple of good overs, and everything can change. So that's best done when a partnership sticks for a while and the batsmen are really setting in.
But I like this boy, Russo, the way he goes about his game. Very organized. He's only 22 years of age. That means he can only become better with all this experience. And he was not running on that occasion because the next ball is going to be a free hit. He was not going to give it to Bogus.
No real question where that is over the line. And well over the line. Happens sometime when the bowler is just striving for a little extra pace. Stride pattern may just lengthen slightly.
Slower ball from Rana.
High up in the air, there's a man under it, and taken. But it was a free hit.
And it's another no ball, so that's going to be another free hit.
Well, Rana Naveed won't be happy about this. Got a chance to correct it and landed just about the same place again.
Now this could be the break the Basnahira cricket Dundee's needed. If Bogus can put this free hit away, momentum with the batting team.
And of course the field can now be changed. Third man comes up. Long on, long off, back. Deep cover. That's cross haul down to deep mid wicket. And it's another no ball.
There's the hat trick. Hat trick of no balls. Hat trick of free hits.
Well, we've had two free hits so far. This will result in another one. And none of those free hits has gone for a boundary.
Yet to his credit, but yet he's relieving the pressure on the batsman, and it's kind of unacceptable because he's a very experienced bowler. He's been around the traps, plays a lot of counter cricket. Bogus will know a lot about him because Rana Naveed does turn out for Tasmania down in Australia.
Stroke down to mid off to end the over. Or has it? No, we still have one more. This is a long one.
But see how well he's bowled though. Three free hits in the over and he's still only gone for 9 runs. We might actually need to reassess the pitch and our targets, Gooch. There's got to be a reason that the batsmen are struggling.
They'll run another quick one and get through. 10 from the over, it's 81 for 2. Of official broadcasters, and down at the bottom my good friend Sajiva, who's in the Maldives now, golfing buddy. will be able to pick up our broadcast on MediaNet, and of course you can pick it up on YouTube, all produced by Grey Matter and Sports Works. So we've had 12 overs, 81 for 2 the score. This could be tricky. Oh, bad throw.
He's done well to get that ball and fling it back to the keeper, Gunaratna. He's not the most agile of players, but yet, when it comes to your bone bowling, you don't want to concede any runs at all.
Well, they were thinking about two. Would have been a bad idea. They're just going at around 6.5 of Basnahira. Haven't been able to get this, the run rate up to 7 or above. That's where they'd like to be at this point in time. Just past the halfway mark. Got wickets in hand, so coming to the time when they've really got to up that rate.
Well, up to the 15th over, I'll look at hitting the 100 mark. The last 5 overs, 45 to 50 is realistic. That would be the way I will look at it. And 145, 150, in these conditions, you definitely will stay competitive.
I think with wickets in hand, they should be showing a bit more urgency at this point. To take the fight to the bowlers a little bit more. They've been consent to just knock it around.
Or maybe they just have a score in mind. They're looking to get there. They've identified that the wicket is very difficult to score off. Very slow. Had quite a few games on this pitch. And they just want to make sure that they get there. And then rely on their bowling and fielding to do the job.
I just think that at this point they're creating a little bit more pressure on themselves than they should. Should be a little bit more aggression, and maybe they'll talk about it when this over finishes, because there's going to be a strategic timeout. No run from the last one. 13 overs have been bowled. It's 85 for 2 and we're going to have a strategic timeout. We're back. That's the situation as things stand with Russo on 30, Borges on 28. Let's have a look at the wickets that have fallen so far.
First to go was Dan Smith in the very first over. Ball nipping in, causing all the problems. A poor shot in the end. Then Tilakaratna Dilshan again to the Indaka, Madhushanka Ekanayaka, rattling the stumps. it's because they look to play square of the wicket on more occasions. You do end up finding that gap between bat and pad. Bowling shared around. It's been good. Very disciplined. Plenty of options available for Jehan Mubarak going into the last 7 overs of his innings.
And a very moderate skyline there for Basnahira. Not too many good overs. So, have done a pretty good job with the ball. But we're at the point now, as we were discussing before, Russell, where a little bit of, they've got to put the pedal to the metal now and just up this run rate slightly, so that the last 5 overs or so they won't be under as much pressure to get to the score that they're looking for, which would have to be somewhere around between 140, 145 and 150.
I'm with you, Dooch, and that's why Kepler-Wessels taking the opportunity to take the strategic timeout, 13th over, and just reassessing how they go about it and where they want to end up.
Well, let's see if we can see a bit of a change in attitude. Pierce, the bowler. And that's whipped away, not timed as well as he'd have liked, and another single results.
The message has been passed on. Russo straight away charging Pieris. Pieris is not express, has the ability just to move that ball around. Former Sri Lankan under 19 captain. A useful batsman too. Uthura Rudras have played him in every game so far.
And he's bowled him. This one just didn't bounce enough. Tried the ramp shot and missed. And down go the stumps.
Well, that's been the shot that the batsmen have been preferring when they were looking for the boundary. But not on this occasion, Bogus. Just as you'd expect, going across the wicket and hoping for a little bit of bat.
Not sure if that execution was too good either. But Bogus goes for 28, and it's 86 now for 3. Mamadullah is the new batsman. Average of 18, a strike rate of just over 100. He's got 150, so not that experienced and not that fast a score either, Russell.
Yeah, he's in for his first game of the tournament. Bangladeshi international he is. He's got his work cut out. They need to get a move on, and he's out there because Cameron Bogus
really did not execute properly. Got too far inside and too far away from the ball. That shot should be more played with the ball coming straight at you. A la Dilshan got himself in a tangle and got Pierce a wicket.
Just flicking the bail, the top of that bail.
Wasn't even in the ballpark.
Riley Russo from South Africa. Born in Bloemfontein, if I'm right. Very early days for him. But to me, he's a man you need to look out for in the future.
Toshir, but I don't think they'll be able to get two.
Because the experience that he's gaining in these conditions, the more cricket he plays, will serve him well.
This has really become a very slow part of the game. Not a whole lot happening. Just inching. Basnahira just inching towards 100. They should be racing towards it now. That's hit pretty firmly. Will not go all the way. Results in a couple. We haven't seen a lot of runs being scored, but we have seen a little action. At one point, things slowed down so much that only the dancing girls were there for relief. He's trying to push things along. He's come out. Look positive. But they'll need to go a lot harder. 14 overs gone. It's 93 for 3. Just six or so overs really been taken advantage of. The power play has been pretty mild in terms of run scoring. The Basnahira is concerned. Still haven't found a way to pick up the pace, but Mandy has. Where are you?
I'm here with Cameron here from the Basnahira Cricket. Dundee. Cameron, good knockout there.
Thanks. Yeah, it was sort of a little bit tough. The wicket was a bit slow, so hopefully we can kick on now and get a competitive total.
You know, another not really up to par innings from Tilakaratne Dilshan. How's he feeling now?
He's feeling pretty well. He's still hitting the ball well, and you know, he's our leading run scorer, so he's having a pretty good tournament. We just need to lift the rest of our output, so he's going okay.
The Basnahira's team started out well, but you guys need a victory now desperately, don't you?
Yeah, it's a must-win game for us. We need to get a competitive total. Anything over 140, I think, is very competitive, and you know, we need to defend it with everything we've got.
On this pitch, you think you'll reach that?
I think so, yeah. I think we've got plenty of wickets in the shed, and you know, 8 or 9 and over from here gets us 145, which will be very competitive.
How's your experience in Singapore, in Sri Lanka been so far, especially here in the Mahindra Sri Lanka Premier League?
Yeah, I'm loving it. You know, the people are great, and you know, it's a great place to play cricket. So everything's been great so far. We just need to get a win tonight, and everything will be good.
Okay, thanks very much, and good luck. Cameron there saying desperate for a win here tonight. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Mandy. Here we go, Gunaratne. Continue with his off spinners. When he gets around to it.
A slight hold up with Russo loosing his boot.
Big swing, and will it make it? Yes, it will. Found the gap, Mamadullah.
We waited a long while for that one. But Mamadullah, he's looked very positive from the moment he walked in. Doesn't time this one either. But he gets the gap. Outfield pretty quick.
Just 3 wickets down. It's time to really step on it now. That run rate still around 6.7. He's ramped that one away. Pervez pulls it back. Eventually they complete 2.
Very good running from Russo. Initially from Mamadullah, who did really well to get it away from the fielder. Who That takes the Basnahira cricket Dundee's past the 100.
Perez Mavrouf struggling. He's just coming back from injury.
We haven't seen him bowl today. He bowled in the game before.
Well, I gather it's a back injury that he had. And he's not really ready to bowl yet, so he plays, he's basically playing as a batsman. The 100 comes up in the 15th over, which is a bit belated. I would reckon it would have to be a mad scramble from here now, Russ. Mavrouf goes at it, not successful. Gets himself a single, and at the end of 15 overs, it's 103 for 3. It's going to have to be a mad scramble from here for these last five overs if Basnahira are going to get up to something decent and to take you through the scramble. When they've swallowed their pizza, it'll be Dean Jones and Jeff Thompson.
And out. I've just swallowed the last bit of dinner, and there's the great catch. The skipper, brilliant catch, diving forward. And this is how they actually got to finish it off here. They need to get a win. They've lost four in a row here, and that is a very good catch, skipper.
Well, he swallowed that at cover, didn't he? Talking about swallowing, that wasn't too hard. It hung in the air for a little bit. He didn't really crunch this runner to be. He held it back, and that's a pretty good catch. Good piece of fielding, too handy. Though normally you see him go one, he's gone two. He's cleaned it up nicely. Abdullah, 13, unlucky number, 103 for 4.
Mendes comes to the crease now. A strike rate of 116. He's got a 67 in there. Just under five overs to bat. Nice little whip to the leg side, looking for two. A call for it, and they should get it.
And Mendes is out there because of this. The wicket fell. Mamadoula tried to force the issue, and a very good piece of cover fielding there put an end to his little aspirations.
Well done to Mubarak, moving forward, diving, kept the elbows away from knocking the ball away. Quick single again, direct hit, no, you've got to pick it up first.
They should be weary in there, that mid-wicket fielder. He's a bit slow there, should be, no, they're looking to milk this guy. They're not scoring too many boundaries, so the bunt is on, as we say, in the middle there, in those short areas, looking for quick singles.
Yeah, this is the time when the skipper, he's just kicked him out of mid-wicket there for a misfield there, and he's got to put himself in the hot spot because he's one of the best fieldsmen. We've already seen a great catch from him already in this over. It's time to get your best fieldsmen in the hot areas. Down the ground, there's someone there, but he can't catch that. Another six, the third six of the innings.
Well, he wasn't quite tall enough, was it? It wouldn't have been tall enough on a stepladder. It was a good hit. Just walked inside of it a little. Run and a beat. Tries to cramp him for a little bit of room. But he just backed away a touch and picked it up. And that one's gone 84 by the measurer.
I've been impressed with Russell, how he's hit the ball today, the way he's tempered his innings, the way he's planned and strategised. Mind you, he got away with that. The first time in his innings, he's taken his eyes off the ball there.
He played a miss at a few off-breaks earlier on, Rasu. He doesn't move his feet a lot to the spinners. And that one there caught him a little bit unawares. Manu Naveed just upped the issue a bit. It was a little unlucky. It just popped in no man's land. But that's what you expect when the field spreads.
So 10 runs from the over. They're looking at 146 to 150 at the moment. Full toss. Nice shot down the ground for one. And that will conclude the over. 11 runs from it. That's 114 for four. For 4 to 7 extras as well. They've got a good launching point to get to close to 150. It all depends on who will bowl the last four overs. The death bowlers are so important. Runner Naveed obviously will bowl one. Dupree will bowl one as well, hasn't he? Had a great day. And Ekenaaki, he will probably bowl one as well. So there you go. They haven't got another spinner in here, another six bowler.
Edelnag is going to get a chance with one of those overs. He's going to have a go from that top end. And he has got one for 26 from three so far.
Just looking at that Sri Lankan flag there, Tomo. They've got a lot of lions on it. I haven't seen a lion at all in Sri Lanka. I wonder why they do that. England's the same. Why do they have lines on their flags when they don't live there? Anyway, in the air, is it enough? There's no one out there. Will it bounce hard to run away for four? Oh, good effort. Tripped over a daisy there, but they're looking for three. Oh, he's in a bit of trouble here. He's in a bit of trouble. We might go to the third umpire.
I tell you what, I think he may make this one, but this throw would have been a little close to the stump, so he'd have been out. Absolutely dead in the water. He still might be out. Good piece of fielding. Chops that off. Right. That's fine. Then turns around. They decide they're going to run another one. Here we are. Just have a look at it again. That's all nice. That's fair. They're just checking to see that that was a boundary. It wasn't a boundary. And then they're still running. And then a strong arm. Look at this. Oh, I don't know still. We've got to slow that down.
Wasn't it a magnificent piece of fielding? That's the stuff we want to see in the Mahindra Sri Lanka Premier League. That could change the whole match. Here it is there. He's picked it up. That's not going to tell us too much. Here we go. Ever so slowly. He's got the ball. And he's out. Brilliant work. How good is that?
Well, that's superb. And it was all because of desperation in the field. And then he needed to back it up with a super arm. And I tell you what, the young bloke out there, a good arm. And Rasu, well, he had a good innings, but, well, he just tried one too many. He's gone for 44, 116 for five.
Fifth wicket has fallen here. 5 for 116 and Timoth Karunaratne. 116, the strike rate there. Best of 50. And they need to get a wriggle on now if they want to get up to 150. He hasn't got time really to get his eye in here.
No luxury, Dino, on that department.
Oh, that's courage for you. First nut, and he's done that. Fantastic. I could never do that.
Well, I think it's the last shot you'd expect the batsman that's just come to the crease first ball to play to you. And then expect him to hit it. Just have a look at this. He gets into position well, watches it well. That's pitched at middle stump too. Could have gone over the stump, but it's on middle stump line. That's a good shot.
It's a big trend. How do you stop guys from doing it? Doing it again. He's out. Oh, he's out. I hit it right in the middle. That's how you stop blokes from doing it.
I tell you, the fellow at short fine leg there, Dino, was moving around for that as the bowler was running in. He could see him lining up to do it, and he was just hoping he kept it down enough. You watch. I'm not going to see it there, but he moves across. The fella here moved around and caught. That was a good piece of anticipation by that fella there. Maharu was trying to pick it up, and he did pick it up in the end. So another one goes down, and it's 620.
Damika Prasad comes in, poor strike rate. He needs to get the strike to Mendes as quick as he can. We'll bring the fine leg up. So obviously a lot of the Sri Lankan players know where they hit. Play a lot of cricket amongst each other. So obviously he must be pretty good at hitting the ball down the ground because they've brought the fine leg up into the circle.
Well, he's only got a top score of 9 or something, so he hasn't had too many goes, but that's in this cricket.
It is. Hits it down the ground for 1.
And this is how the wicket fell. Scooped it around the corner 1 too many times. And a good anticipated catch. Foolish guy. Maru. And you just can't see it, but he did run around one of those dots while that guy was trying to play the shot there. While Rasu was trying to play the shot, he anticipated it, ran to his right about 5-6 metres to take that catch. Good cricket.
It had a bit of heat on it. It was a good catch. Call was 2 straight away. They won't get them, but I like the attitude. 8 runs from this over. 8 runs and over now, getting close to 150. Happy hour, as we called it, the last few overs here.
Well, 150 be competitive, Dino. Both of these teams have struggled to bat properly, and I think Basnahira, who in at the moment had the better batting attack, so 150 might be well and truly enough.
Round, they'll get another one. Won't take another one. No, they won't. So 9 runs from the over, 123 for 6. Here's the breakdown from the score there. 123 for 6, 3 sixes, 9 fours, 1 3, which is quite rare in this form of the game, and 41 dot balls. So we've got 18 balls to go. I reckon I'll get 152. There you go. That's my guess.
Well, the only way they're not is by getting bowled out. And Dupree's coming back on, and he bowled pretty well to start with. So he might have something to say in this.
Bowling to Prasad, who I've got a feeling likes to go down the ground to hit. That's his strength. Down there, inside edge, so should get a single. They do.
Yeah, it was a good enough miscue to get away with it, wasn't it? Got caught up in his bat, his pads, his feet, and then just dribbled away and enabled him to get the run. Wasn't a bad ball, this. Could have quite easily chopped that on.
Good example there, another batsman not wearing spikes in the back of his footwear. Don't know why they do it, because your knees, spikes in your heels to pull up, and already seen a few run-outs already. They don't learn. Now, the third man has come up. Jeffrey, now that means they must, he must bowl the ball full. He tried to run it down the third man. Clip on the leg side. Good captaincy.
Yeah, it was a good piece of bowling. Well, you have to bowl to it as much as anything, and all he can do is bunt it to the guy at short square. Not many other options for him to play, but that shot, and it's just a single. That's no great shakes.
Third man's up, so again, well aware of where he wants to hit the ball. Just get bat on it, young man. Just get bat on it. Give the strike to your partner.
That's the wide of off stump Yorker ball. Getting fairly popular in these matches.
There's two lengths, Tomo, as you know. They teach them to bowl full and wide outside off stump. That is hit one target there, and the other target is full and straight at leg stump. That's the two defensive lines and lengths for the bowlers at this. Down the ground for one. The stump's a lot from the boundary today.
Yeah, I don't think I'd be letting it hit the stumps at this stage. That ricochets. That one only needed a little bit more, and it's going to ricochet for a couple of extra runs there. I'm not going to get run out. I'll be stopping it from hitting him.
Again, will he hit if he's out? Oh, good running. Geez, quick. Mendes, very, very quick.
Well, he's quick, but Mubarak was a little slow there around square leg. You should be knowing he's looking for this. I mean, you watch what the batsmen do, don't you, Dino, to see which shot they're going to play. He was always going to chip it around the corner.
I think Prasad likes to hit the ball. Down the ground there, only one more. Very good bowling indeed by Dupree. End of the over, 5 runs from it. 2 overs to go, 120 out for 6. To go, and 128 for 6 here, and I think most of the runs will have to be scored by Mendes. I dare say looks the better batsman of the two. Some of the owners there, and Rana Naved to bowl the penultimate over. Swing and a miss outside off stump.
That was the old slower delivery, that one, wasn't it? He wound it up. Looked like he was really going to let it go, and it just fizzed out. Very good disguise. Looks normal there, and he lets it go. And look at it, it just comes down at rat pace. That totally deceives the bowler, the batsman, sorry, out of the back of the hand.
Inside edge, they'll get one.
They haven't given them much to hit, have they, in these last few?
They've hit their defensive targets, the bowlers. This is what the coaches will speak to their the death bowlers. And it's either going to be a change-up delivery or bowl a full outside off stump or full out leg stump. So, Bree will bowl the last over, dare say, after running a bit. In the air, this might be caught. Is someone getting under it? How did that lob in between those two? Honestly, and they get two.
Oh, the man at deep mid-off should have made a better attempt than this.
I don't think he picked it up. Let's have a look here. I think he was thinking it was coming to him flatter. Dupree there, and oh, he wasn't even in the hunt, was he?
I don't mind seeing him drop the ball by going for it hard, but when you don't go for it like that, I'd be very annoyed.
Off the toe, put some chalk on that cue. There you go, that's a bit of attitude with the fielding. Now that's what we're looking for. Nice piece of work there.
It was, wasn't it, much crisper than the previous attempt. There we are, dives on a one-handed pick, clean pick, and throws it back on. This keeps the batsman honest.
Well, you know, you don't take two on him, that's the thing. You create a reputation. In the air, did he get all of it? Did he get all of it? He did. Good hit down the ground. Not too many times you see a fieldsman behind the bowler's arm there.
Well, that's directly over the stumps, I reckon, that one. Straight down the ground. You couldn't have got any straighter. Short of a length, but he still goes through with the shot. He's got enough area there to clear his arms and slog that one. Too much width. And that's what I mean about how direct it went.
Looking for two. They should get them. Should get them easily. Good running. Good running indeed. It's 12 runs from the over. 140 for six. Little good cameos from Mendes and Prasad there. Nice partnership, 20 from 15. One over to go, six balls, 140 for six. I did say, I reckon they get 152. And I think 150 might get them a win here. I really do. Paris or Paris. Good bat on that. He's looking for two. Will he take him on? He won't.
Maruf down there at mid-odd had to be quick. They're always going to push it. No room for knock-ons here or fumbles.
Sometimes if you've got to sacrifice your wicket, though, to keep the best batsman on strike. And they're the little sacrificial acts done by players. Sometimes you just got to keep the best player on strike somehow. Anyway, Prasad, he's already hit a six, so he might be able to do the job. Inside edge, gone for four. Inside edge, gone for four. Leg byes, actually, sorry. So,
Yeah, the keeper would have been unclear there to sight that. Here's the shot. A little in-swinger. Well, off-cutter, I mean. Oh, he's got a huge inside edge.
It's an inside edge.
Yeah, no wonder the keeper didn't pick it up, eh?
Don't know how the umpire gave it leg bias, but he did. Oh, down the ground. There is someone out there. Has he picked the gap again? He has. Outstanding. I'll get my hand on it. Oh, I thought I got past him.
Well, he almost overran it, didn't he? A cup of Gadara. Trying to get around and he overran the delivery. It's a scoop shot, that one, isn't it? Just shoveled it, really.
Bowler not hitting his defensive lengths, then he'll get hit for four. He's got to get it full and straight. It's better. So two more balls to go. Dilshan, who's not that well at the moment, not doing that well. Hepler Vessels there in the background, the coach. So, can they get 152? The bat on it there. Well, I need to get a four here. So, 148 for six. That gets Mendes on strike. He's yet to hit a boundary. He's due.
Well, he's overdue. He's got one ball to do it with.
I think he's better off than using the bowler's pace somehow, running it down to third man or fine lapping it, as in the Dilshan scoop around the corner. Use the bowler's pace. He hasn't bowled a change-up delivery. Down the ground. Must run two. Must look for two. Good stuff. Sacrificial axe. Keep running. Keep running. Well done. Very good running by these two. Fantastic running. And that got their 150 up. Very good running by Prasad. He's the one that pushed him, Mendes. He didn't really want to come back for the second one. And that's a nice little finish. A nice little flurry there by Basnahira.
Yeah, they did well to keep this going. It was a bit slow, a bit hard to start with. But they just kept at it, kept chipping away at the total. 150, as we said, in a night match. Well, it didn't prove too good last night, but there was a phantom Mahela batting out there, and he won't be there tonight, and it could be enough. Only time will tell, but that's how it's happened. Smith came in. He's been out of form, and that didn't change at all. Dilshan was out for 14. He's been cooked for about a week. Rasu was good, and Bogus, and just got away to 150.
Here's the bowlers there, and the best bowler, Dupree. 1 for 17. He was outstanding, really was. I thought Gunaratne was very good. No wicket for 26. But all in all, 11 extras, probably a few too many to him. 150 for six. Well, I believe we've got Tom Moody down on the boundary.
Certainly have the big Tom Moody here with me, the coach of the Uthura team. Tom, do you think you've done enough for this game?
Well, if we bat well, yeah, that's the most important thing. I think we fielded pretty well, so defensively it was good, and it was good also to see a couple of our young bowlers step up and perform.
So planning to spoil the party of Basnahira, are you?
I'm not worried about their party. I'm just worried about making sure that we get some points on the board. It's we've had a pretty tough tournament to date, so it's important that we finish strongly. I know there's a number of players in the dressing room are keen to not only perform well for themselves, but they're keen for the team to get some points.
A win here, what would it mean to Uthura?
Oh, it means a lot. This is, we're here for the long haul. We know we're developing a team. We've got some exciting young talent. So, look, as I've said, it hasn't quite gone our way so far this tournament. That's 2020 cricket. If you don't get momentum early, which we haven't done, it's very hard to recapture it. So, we're learning all the time, and hopefully we can get, a good result here tonight and go to Colombo and finish off the job in our sixth game.
Yeah, you said you have seen some exciting talent. Would you like to name a few players?
Oh, just one, Chathra, the left armer. He's, he's one of our under 21 players. I just like the way he goes about it. He's an all rounder, but he's more than happy to take responsibility. We're using him, in the pressure overs, which is a really important part of his learning. And I'm sure he'll, gain some, you know, massive experience from that opportunity and come back a better cricketer.
Tom, thank you very much and good luck for the rest of the tournament.
My pleasure. Cheers.
Well, that's it from here.
Well, there you go. There's the target. Tom Mooney, a double World Cup champion there. The Uthura Rudras need 151 runs to win from 20 overs at 7.55 runs per over. Don't go away. We've got the innings straight after the break.
Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League. Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League.
Welcome back here to the Pallekele Stadium in Kandy. Basnahira won the toss and decided to bat, and this is how they went. 44 from Rousseau, the top score. Let's have a look at the wickets. Ross.
Dan Smith again bowled in the first over. Dilshan just couldn't get going, struggled with his timing. And after a partnership, Cameron Bogus attempting that scoop, playing the wrong line. Mahmudullah gave some movement or momentum for the Basnahira Cricket Dundee's team. Do so towards the end of the innings while opening his arms out. And trying to push that score along, finding himself short. Karunaratne didn't last long.
Those were the six wickets that fell. The bowling, two wickets for Ekanayaka, but pretty economical for most of the bowlers. A wicket each for Perez, for Pries, Dupries rather, Perez and Rana Naveed. So this is what is needed. The Rudras need 151 to win from 20 overs, and they'll have to do that at 7.55 per over. We'll be back shortly with their reply.
Sri Lanka! This is SLPO.
Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League. Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League.
And we're back with you as the Uthura Rudras are about to make their reply to Basnahira's 150 for six. Rudras openers make their way out. Tilakaratne Dilshan will be attempting to organize his bowlers, get some early wickets, get some points on the board, and set the Rudras back. 151, reasonable total, but not necessarily one that you can be comfortable defending, Russ.
It's a slow pitch, and we've seen batsmen struggle, so I think they'll have to bat very well to get there. Imran Farhat, experienced opening batsman, plays for Pakistan. Look at that strike rate, almost a 150. He's an important member in this chase.
Here comes Jayaratna. The inside edge, it seems, off the first delivery. So the Rudras are away.
Lahiru Jayaratna from the Hunaskiri, just 20 years of age. Can be sharp, is one that are looking to the future for. He'll be bowling to Roshan Silva, who's basically had a promotion up the order. He's played in the games in the middle order before.
Quite finding it as yet, Jayaratna.
There is a massive incentive in winning this tournament. The winner goes on to play in the Champions League next month. Of course, Sri Lanka do have a place in the qualifiers leading up to the Champions League, but it gives you a good shot at it.
They'll just get a single. Gets Silva off the mark. Hope he's not related to that lion, Russell.
Well, the lion, where is he? The last time I saw him, he was trying to entertain the cheerleaders.
Last time I saw him, he was grossly overweight. Just to keep him honest, and it's called a wide.
Well, the batting to come for the Uthura Rudras: Brendan Taylor, Jayan Mubarak, the skipper, Dylan Dupree, Charmer Kopagadara, Harvis Maruf playing solely as a batsman. Janaka Gunaratna can hit the ball.
There's no question that they have the firepower. It's all about the start.
The question of staying in front all the while, because the moment you fall behind, it's very tough to claw your way back in. Looks like he doesn't trust his upper order. Ready.
Hiked away, and it'll go all the way. Farhat just opening his shoulders.
In the slot, floated up to Imran Farhat by Jayaratna. And of course, he gets curving to the left-hander, who can easily line him up.
He's a naturally aggressive player, Imran Farhat. Look to make the most of this six overs when there are just two men outside the circle. Deep mid wicket has now been dropped back. Fine leg is up.
A That's more the length. We've seen a lot of batsmen struggle when the ball's been just short of a length. When you float it up to the bat, of course, it's an easy hit. That in-between length.
Got very, very close to him as well. No way that was there for the cut. That's the end of the first over. 9 from it. Standings, and that line in the middle denotes those that will go forth into the semis at this point. Basnahira and Uthura languishing at the bottom. Damika Prasad. Driven well, not well enough to get to the boundary, but enough to get the batsman too.
It's a different attack for the Basnahira Cricket Dundees. They've left out the senior fast bowlers Dirk Nannis and also Sean Langefeld. Dilshan going into the game trusting local quicks, and also going in with a lot of slower bowlers. Mahmudullah brought in, Dilshan will bowl a few. August and Turney's arm around. Jeevan Mendis and Rangan Herath will of course lead that attack.
Well, this one is driven perfectly. There will be no chasing that.
Gets rid of the slip as well. But poor bowling. See, right underneath the bat. At all, there's no swing for Damika Prasad. An easy pickings. This is the last thing you need. Imran Farahat, get off to a flyer.
Well, he's looking in good nick, Imran Farahat. Strikes the ball with a lot of power. Business again. Dilshan may be a little bit upset that Prasad is over pitching.
Got plenty of fielders in that extra cover area. Imran Farahat started with a bang. Just seems it's all or nothing from him.
It's in the air. Will anyone get to it? Just drops too far. But that's the intention, to hit it over the top. Just didn't get fully hold of it. Farahat.
Sliced it. Was going down the ground over the bowler's head. The angle, taking the ball towards extra cover, but they wanted it. Just have a look at Dilshan and Bogus. Tear after that one.
Delivery, they'll still get a single.
Good call. He's just hit a boundary, got a couple of twos through that extra cover area, and then get off strike. There would be there needs to be communication between the two batsmen. I drop, you run. It's very important that you do have that understanding. It gives you those extra runs as well as it eases pressure.
It's always good when you keep the fielders in the circle on their toes, when they know that you'll drop it and you'll run, as well as try to go over the top. Again, to create some pressure. Oh, inside edge. This is the stumps. Single to finish the over. It's 19 without loss.
Run scorers in the Mahindra's LPL. Kamran Akmal leading the way. Dilkarakar Dilshan, Tamim Iqbal. The man of the series, the Mahindra man of the series. This is what he will walk away with. Mahindra XUV 500. That's if it's returned in good shape after Dooj and Dino drive it back to Colombo.
Dino keeps quiet and I help and let me concentrate. We should get there pretty safely. Karaf on to ball. Dilshan did say that he played three spinners, expects them to do the job. He's got them in the first five overs, the first six overs, inside of that, in the power play. That'll be one.
Good use of the feet from Roshan Silva. It's got a healthy first class average. Average is about 50, but in the T20 format, we'd really like to get those numbers up.
I think Imran Farhat might take a slightly different approach here. Onside field heavily populated, three men in the circle, two out, long on, deep mid wicket. But there's nobody at deep backward square leg.
Well played. He had to come at the pads, lined him up beautifully. All he needed was a decent piece of back to get it over the top of short square leg.
He's gone out for it again. Just to squeeze a single out of it. It was tight, but good decisive running.
Bogus was the fielder. He knew which batsman he wanted, and he'd had his man, but the throw way off its mark. They have to field well. Cricket Dundees, they have let themselves down in this tournament so far. Lots of drop catches and also lots of fumbles in the field. Direct hits they've missed. But here is an opportunity to put everything right. It's 25 for no loss.
44 and 28 from Rousseau and Borges, respectively. Set up Basnahira's 150 for 6 with some good bowling. Anayake and Dupreez. That's smacked and gone a long, long way.
That's a massive hit. And he's just treating Damika Prasad as he was a medium pacer. Look at the swing of the bat. Well balanced. That's a maximum that he'll always enjoy watching over and over again.
Had everything. It had the elevation, came out the middle of the bat, went a mile across the boundary. It's a little bit wider, but he's going to go at anything that gives him a bit of room, Imran Farhat. That's the way he bats.
Yeah, but the key to Farhat is he goes after the balls that are in his zone. Second longest six that we just saw being hit by Imran Farhat. Tamim Iqbal's 102 meters was down in Colombo.
It's probably still going.
It's very important that you know your strengths and weaknesses. And Imran Farhat is one of those. If it's up to him, he'll give it a whack. If not, he works it around. And that's the way to go. Can't go after every ball. That's not his strength. I've seen a lot of batsmen try this, trying to be cheeky. Just doesn't come off.
Well, if he just stood his ground, he could have worked that off his body quite easily down to fine leg. These premeditated shots, really not necessary. Way ahead of the game now, need to take any chances. Bowled him. Middle stump.
Well, he's missed one. Didn't really need to go after it, as you just said. He was well on top. Midon was also pushed to the long on fence. But that ball goes the other way. Imran Farhat off to a flyer. 26 he's made. Uthura Rudras are 32 for 1.
Batsman is Mubarak, the captain of the Uthura Rudras. He's got a few matches under his belt and he's not a stranger to big scores. And this is why he's here. Imran Farhat just running down the wicket and taking a wild swing at Prasad and having his lumber yard shattered. Going at a good clip and things could very well slow down now with a new batsman in. Just trying to go straight down the ground and that one just went across him a little, as you'd expect a right-hander to a left-hander, but he got outside leg stump, exposed his stumps. Prasad hit them. Thank you. new batsman is a good chance to get in some duck balls.
And they should.
Well, that's not the way to play yourself in. That didn't have the length for playing that shot. Four overs gone, it's 32 for one.
They do bat deep, the Uthura Rudras, but they need to bat well though. They need to get in partnerships. One of these batsmen needs to dig in. Jayaratna, he's back into the attack. We had one over of spin. The moment we've seen the back of Imran Farhat, it's time to go back to the basics. First over, going for 9 runs off Jayaratna, and you know the reason why, because Imran Farhat was at the wicket.
Roshan thought of putting in a slip, but he's now taken him out, put him at mid-wicket. Third man, fine legger back, everybody else is at home.
He's missed out. Short and wide, should have done better, Mubarak. Hits it hard, straight to the fielder. It's the sign of a batsman not in form. Lots of good shots going to the fielders.
It's just not being able to find the gaps. He's getting the balls to hit. Roshan really taking a bit of a chance here. I think with that line, he maybe want to drop a man deep on the cover boundary. Or a deep point. Mid wicket now has come out. And what are we going to do? We're going to have a ring of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in the offside. Don't think that was the ball that he was expecting, the bowler to bowl.
Yeah, he gets extra protection on the offside and goes straight. Again, Mubarak missing out. So it's a sign of lack of confidence, I would say. The team has really struggled. They've had 4 losses so far. When you're confident, you know, the back of your mind, subconsciously, you'll just make the adjustments with the wrists, with the face of the bat, and find those gaps.
Slip is in. Waited on it and timed it really well. It's not going to go all the way. And they settle for 2. It was a slower delivery. And it caught Silva on the front foot. He waited on it.
Yeah, he hit it on purpose. He was looking for the gap. And it definitely has slowed up after the exit of Imran Farhat.
Again, not being able to find the fielder, rather to find the gap. And at the end of 5 overs, they're not where they want to be. They're 36 for 1. the Rudras having a little trouble getting going. They just lost the one wicket and it's still early in the piece. And hopefully the next two commentators will help one of these two teams to get going. It's Roshan Abasinghe and Jeff Thompson.
Certainly hope, dudes. We certainly hope Mahmudullah is coming on. Mahmudullah, of course, he's from Bangladesh, playing in his first game for Basnahira Dundee's in this Mahindra SLPL. Uthura Rudras at the moment doing reasonably well. 36 for one. We're going at 7.5. Mubarak on strike. And drives it square, straight to the man at cover. They will go through quickly for a single. So the game evenly poised, Tomo.
It is evenly poised. It's a bit slow at the moment. It's as the previous commentator said, Mubarak's been hitting the ball. I don't think he's out of form so much. It's just all with the hitter. He's been hitting the ball in the middle, but the ring there, it's hard to get away. It's staying a bit low, the pitch at the moment. I think he's a pretty good batter, and it's just hard work out there at the moment. And he's not getting much relief from the other end, much help, you know. You've got to help one another to get this score.
Strikes him on the bat. He's asked the question. That looked pretty adjacent to me. It was in line, and he was swinging a delivery that was in line. And Mahmudullah's bat delivery was going straight through.
Yeah, Silver's tried to up the ante here. Let's have a look. It's not going to miss, is it? Knee roll right in front of middle stump. And, well, he had to hit it, and he didn't hit it. He was trying to force the issue, and it didn't work. He heads to the dressing room, and it's 37 for two.
The Zimbabwean Brendan Taylor is out there. Rudras, 37 for two. That ball spun. That certainly spun. He didn't know much about it, Taylor. Played pretty late.
No, he didn't. Did he? Didn't know much about this at all. This pitch is dried out, and it should grip more tonight. It looked pretty dry and pretty dusty this afternoon.
This has been a good over. He's so far got through four balls with just a single and a wicket. That's the kind of breaks that you'd want to put on the Uthura Rudras batsman, because they were going quite smoothly. Heavily bowled again. Another slow delivery, nicely looped. Very pace to play with for Brendan Taylor. That was his problem. He was wanting to use whatever pace available. Just didn't have anything on the ball.
Yeah, Mubarak knows that, and he's not willing to let him get some pace. Although, mind you, I wouldn't be surprised to see a dart somewhere.
Well, they'll get a single anyway off the last ball, but this is a very good over. 38 for two. Absolutely nothing in it. 38 for two, 38 for two after six overs. And another change in the bowling. It's going to be the left-arm spinner, Ranganathan. He'll bowl to Brendan Taylor. Going to bowl with a slip.
I thought Harath would be a handful on this tonight. Little fella, a little bit lower. He throws it up, he varies it good.
Now this is chipped in the air, might be out caught. He is taken quite easily by Jarrad there, long off. Well judged. Brendan Taylor just coming down the pitch, looking to chip it over mid-off. And quite a simple catch in the end.
Didn't he know there was a deep mid-off down there? I don't know whether he was trying to hit this for six or not, but he just punched it and a simple catch there. So bad cricket, bad shot, I think, from Taylor. Should have realised there's a man there and another one's gone. It's 38 for three.
Mubarak crossed on that shot, he's on strike, and Herat gets it past the outside edge. That's the one that goes with the arm. Just take a look at this dismissal, Tomo. It was a nothing shot, really. It was, he could have easily hit it harder.
Well, he could have. He struck it pretty well, but he didn't look like he was trying to hit a six to me. He just hit it exactly where he meant to, and there's a fielder there. Well, I just can't work that one out.
Nicely played by Jahan Mubarak. He'll get a single. Take another look at that dismissal. Really didn't go on with the shot. Just a little chip. And found the fieldsman at long off. Simple catch in the end.
The only thing I can think of is he's tried to hit it a bit wider and didn't. Capicadera, the new man in. 130 strike rate. A best of 96, not out. He's going to need a fair bit of that, I think, to get him out of this spot.
He can bat, I can tell you. He can hit the ball hard. And he gets off the mark quickly. Now, this could be trouble. I can tell you, it is definitely trouble. And Jahan Mubarak had some hesitation. And I wonder whether there was ever a run in it.
Well, he looked like he was struggling, didn't he? It's the far end from us here, but I think he's going to be up our way. Well, just have a look, it's broken now, and he's short.
Well, for a moment I thought it was a direct hit. A direct hit would have meant no chance, but the wicketkeeper did collect the ball, and with the bails off, and there you are, third umpire confirms it, and the Rudras seem to have lost another wicket.
Well, I thought this was their biggest chance. The best partnership could have come from these two, but it wasn't so. Mubarak was already in there, and he got gunned, and it's 39 for four.
For four in the seventh over. Rudras suddenly on the back foot after that very fine start. Farvis Maharoof is in. They've lost two wickets in the over. Basnahira will continue to bowl to Maharoof, and they'll get a run. Smith, the wicketkeeper, was after it, but they still managed to go through for a single.
Yeah, it's taken the wind out of their sails, hasn't it? They've gone quiet, in a bit of shock, I think.
They'll get a run off the last ball. It's 41 for four. Well, that's how it looks. They need 110 runs in 13 overs, Tomo. That's a tough ask now.
Yeah, Basnahira won the toss and decided to bat, and that 150 is looking pretty insurmountable for the moment for the Rudras.
That's played fine. They get a run. A lot will depend on Kapugedra and Maharoof. Kapugedra is due for something big. He's a good player. Made his debut as a youngster for Sri Lanka and a player of immense potential, I can tell you.
And he may have just run out his captain, so he better stay out there. I wouldn't get off the field in a hurry if I was him.
Well, it's time for him now to put his hand up and show us all that he is a consistent player. What better moment than this? Maharoof will also get a single, so they'll have to first form a base before they look to attack. But Kapugedra won't be too pleased with that run out, yes, I do agree. Well, they're running another one. They get an overthrow on that. Now, this is the run out we're talking about. Jehan Mubarak, look at the pickup and the underarm from Jeevan Mendes. Great work. Straight to the keeper, and he knew he was gone. He put his finger up straight away.
Yeah, it was a good piece of cricket in close there. One on underarm was going to be the quickest release.
We're looking for at least a couple of runs, but only a single. Just been scoring in singles only in this over. Five so far of four balls. And in the eighth over, that asking rate is now climbing over 8.5. Quite a friendly full toss to Maharoof. Satisfied with a single.
Yeah, they seem more intent, I think, on just not getting out at the moment after what's happened, Roshan, which is not going to help. You're still, if it's there to be taken, you've got to hit the ball to the boundary.
So they get seven off the over. It's 48 for four. Just Farah's 26 to show for the Uthura Rudras, and not really too much of batting left after this pair. Just Dupree and Gunratna. Rana Naveed, Phiris and Ekanayaka don't have great credentials as batsmen. Jeevan Mendes it is, being swung around by Kapugedra. Another single.
No, it didn't look too good, that batting card there, does it? A bit disappointing.
The 50 of the Uthura Rudras. It's coming the ninth over. But asking rate, still gettable, 101 of 70 balls, not difficult. But they need to maintain wickets.
Yeah, the rate's fine. They're on par. It's just those wickets they keep losing consistently. That's just an easy two.
And they look to do this for a while now, at least up to about the 12th or 13th over. Maybe even the 15th, and try not to lose any more wickets. And the last five overs will be the launching pad. Now this is hit in the gap and down to the boundary by Chamara Kapugedra. That was a poor delivery by Mendes.
Yeah, I thought Mendes might have enjoyed this pitch a little bit more tonight, but it's just a little short
in this over here. Drags it down. Just doesn't stay upright enough for me. It just falls away with the ball and dragged it away. That's why that went where it did. And I don't mean off the bat, I mean where it pitched.
That's better. That is definitely better. Held it back a little bit, bowled a little bit slower. Chiman Mendes, you need to tweak it a little bit on this pitch. Try and get something off it. And short and wide. Been a love him a single. Not a bad over for Uthura. It's 57 for 4. And it is time for the strategic timeout. That's the look at the card of the Uthura Rudras in this Mahendra SLPL. Kapugendra is looking good. He's made 14 of 11. Maharup in support. But just far, Imran Farhat at the top, making 26.
Well, this is something you won't see at home. There's lots of different scenery around in Sri Lanka. And one of the main ones is Pinnawala Elephant Orphanage. It's a nursery and a captive breeding ground for wild Asian elephants. Located about halfway between Colombo and Kandy, Pinnawala is notable for having the largest herd of captive elephants in the world. There was a couple outside the ground the other day too. The orphanage was originally founded in order to afford care and protection to many of the orphaned wild elephants found wandering in and near the forests of Sri Lanka. It was established in 1975. That's when I started bowling. That's what I come on the mat too. And set up by the Sri Lankan Department of Wildlife Conservation. Terrific. You won't see anything like that. I just love watching the elephants around here.
That was the time when you were terrifying batsmen, weren't you, Tomo? I said that was the time when you were terrifying batsmen around the world.
Yeah, that's right. I was running in like an elephant.
You certainly had the strength of an elephant, I'm sure.
Yeah, more like that. I wish I had the elephant struck the bowl with. It would have been even quicker.
A change of bowling. It's going to be Thilina Tushara Mirando. And the first delivery being pushed away on the offside. Well, Mandy has been very busy in Kandy. Let's go across and join her once again.
I just knew you would say that. With me there is Roshan Jaleel, a youngster, 121 for the Basnahira Cricket Dundee team. Roshan, I couldn't help but notice all the seniors in the team keep coming and checking up on you. So obviously they're very protective about you.
Yeah, I think first of all it's a wonderful experience, you know, to play with all the big guns and you know, to even, you know, stay with the dressing room, you know, to know what they're talking about, to be around and, you know, share the experiences and how they read the game and, you know, analyze the game. I think to be a part of it is it's just wonderful.
And how special is it to share a dressing room with a legend like Tilakaratne Dilshan?
Yeah, actually it's wonderful, you know, like you know, every time, you know, before a game what he talks and while the game how he encourages players and how he analyzes, you know, overs and stuff and how he reads the game, and I think that's a lot to learn.
And what about the other foreign players in the team? Are you getting to learn a lot from them?
Yeah, actually, especially you know, with the good batsmen, we learned how to bowl and to mix up our variations with them and to know how good they read the balls and stuff. So it's also wonderful.
You're an off spinner. Have you had a chance at all to interact with Murali?
No, actually, I've spoken to him, but I think in this particular league, I've got the opportunity of talking to Ranganeherath and Jeevan Mendis. You know, they are especially about Ranganeherath, one of the top spinners who's playing for the Test in Sri Lanka. You know, talk to him. I've spoken a lot to him, and you know, talking to him itself is it's really wonderful to know.
I believe you're crazy about Shah Rukh Khan.
I don't know who told you that. Yeah, actually, he has been one of my fans, so yeah, I'll...
He's been one of your fans or you've been one of his?
I've been one of his.
Can you sing a song from one of his movies?
I think... Okay, just a tiny one, okay?
Come on.
Tumko bhi hai khabar, mujhko bhi hai pata, ho raha hai juda dono ka rasta.
Fantastic, you're a very sporting boy. Thanks very much for speaking to us. That was Roshan Jaleel, extremely sporting. Back to you guys.
Well, we all knew that he was a Shah Rukh Khan fan and he was crazy about Shah Rukh Khan, and well done to him.
Do you have Sri Lanka's Got Talent show? Is that what we're going at? We have the singing shows?
Oh, we do have. You've just seen talent, Tomo. Straight to the man at cover. They wanted a single. Now, had he collected it? Now, this time, they'll take a run. But had that been collected cleanly, I can tell you, it would have been a close call.
He was a bit anxious to grab it. Well, instead, he's waiting for it to come. He's tried to force his shoe. I'm talking about the bowler here. Now, watch. He snatches at it. We've seen that a couple of times in different games. Just a bit of panic there from the backing up from the bowler's end, and it's cost a couple of run-outs. That one there could have been another one.
Certainly was. Very close. Uthura Rudras didn't want it. This is Mirando. And punched off the back foot. And get a run off the last ball. It's 62 for 4. And the runs are almost the same. It's just that Rudras had lost two more wickets, and it's going neck and neck in the commentary box. It's neck and neck here. Jeff Dujon and Dean Jones.
Thanks, Roshan. Well, after the same number of balls and when Basnahira were batting, it's exactly the same except for the wickets. 62 for 2, 62 for 4, so not much between them. Sweep shot, jeez, has he smashed that for a single? Picking the field out. Capagadera, good player. And he fetched this from a long way outside off stump, but right out to the middle of the bat. And do these bats have middles? And edges as well. Need Uthura Rudras need 87 for 57. Oh, that's just wide of extra cover. Oh, he picked that up and filled that beautifully down there. Brilliant job down there. Just a little bit too short. hitting the holes pretty regularly, these two, which is the way they've got to go. And they're going for two. There's a slight, isn't it? Two there, though.
This is a better shot. And knew that he had to hustle to come back, so turn quickly.
Straight lines, Jeff, that's what was good about that. That was the call, and that was a good call as well. 11 overs gone, 67 for 4. First match was played at the Royals versus Uvernext, and Uvernext won that game pretty easily in the end by 14 runs. Taranga got a nice little 48. Prasanna bowled very well, 4 for 19, as did McDonald. A good performance there, and that'll get Uva second on the table. And of course the top four teams. So everyone's trying to get to the top four teams. And of course, Basnahira need to win this game to have a chance to get the finals. Bowling. Well, that's what happens when you walk across the stump for about a couple of feet. Leave the leg stump open. That's what happens.
Well, I think he made this move a bit too early. I think bowler had a bit of time to line him up. And decided that leg stump would do. And hit it. So Fabiz Maruf goes for 8, and the Rudras are 67 for 5.
Rudras are 5 wickets down now, and really it's all in the hands of Kapagadera and this man, Gunaratne. Good strike rate, 128.2. He has got an 83, so you can't leave him, put him aside. Hope he can play a better shot. Just played by the previous batsman, Maruf. Outside edge, just wider, slips, gone for 4. Nice start. Well, not a great start, but 4 runs anyway.
Well, you take them anywhere you can get them. Maruf was trying to be creative, moved way too early, and literally watched his leg stump get castled.
And Tassara pretty happy with that. They love getting a wicket, these boys. They really do. So 80th from 52 balls now. Oh, swing and miss. Didn't that carry well? That's a sort of delayed appeal there, douche. Oh, what's going on?
Well, at first look, it looked as if it passed pretty close to the edge. Let's have another look. I reckon I heard a sound. I reckon that was a nick. Yes, I think he nicked that.
Let's have a listen.
Here it is. Thin one, ball didn't deviate at all.
Difficult job with trumpets and bands going off and a lot of noise in the crowd. And Dilshan disappointed there with the decision. Still can't believe it was given not out, but they have to get on with it.
They need 80 from 50 balls now. Required run rate 9.6.
Haven't really got much of a time to get on with it here. Gunaretne. Yes, no, wait. Oh, never run on the misfield.
That's just about where you'd want a batting side to be if you're a bowling side at this point. As you know, that a couple of tight overs is going to really cause desperation from the other side once you get it up over 10.
Oh, he's had a big swing down. It's gone an inside edge through mid-wicket. 5 runs from the over, 72 for 5.
Two for five now, and the required run rate 9.88. 79 from 48 balls, and Harat coming on now. He's got 1 for 9. Got a slip.
And are they going to risk it with him? Are they going to try to target him? Very hard to get away. I'm just trying to get the mid wicket in the right position. That might make the batsman want a couple of paddle sweeps as well.
On the leg side, no run. Oh, that's a poor throw. Oh, that's an absolute stinker. What happened there?
He wasn't too happy with this. Just have a look at it here. Just what? And look at that throw to the keeper, douche.
Oh, it couldn't hit water if he fell out of a boat.
Threw it to his wrong side. He's a left-hand throw, but still.
Oh! Well, did he hit the pad first? That's the inquiry.
I reckon that hit the pad first. Definitely.
I thought it was pad first. If that was the case, I dare say in Test cricket they would have been referred, and I dare say would have been given out. But it's not Test cricket, it's T20 cricket, and we ain't got time for it. So, Capagadero.
Oh, they're trying to play him off the back foot. They're waiting for him to bowl a short one.
Really well, Harith. 1 for 12 from 2.4. Typically him. Very miserly. And just watch the skipper here, Dilshan. Will he come out of slip now? He will now. And he'll try and block it up here. They're not too far away of 2 runs per ball, Doos. And you know what happens when we see that at this level of the game. Pulls it away. For 1, just 4 runs from the over at 76 for 5. the Killer Denim Award there, the young player of the tournament, Aranga, Dananjaya, Kumara, and of course, don't forget Jeffrey Robert Thompson's been wearing the Killer Denim as well today. Another single here. Right, now, these boys now have really got to get a rattle on now. They've got 10 runs from 12 balls face, Capicadera particularly. Needs to find some fours and sixes if they're going to win this game from here. They need 74 from 41 balls. Gunaratne needs to either start to hit out now, I dare say. They lose this one, that means they've lost five in a row. Outside edge, four. There you go, that's what we've got to do. Good stuff.
I think he fooled the bowler here. I think he thought the bowler thought he was going to charge him. Bowled it short. And you take them anywhere you can get them.
Change up delivery next ball. Tommy Moody there. Double World Cup champion. Coached Sri Lanka, of course, WA. Oh, that's a wide.
There's been some pretty good fielding so far. The old relay. Good collection and getting rid of the ball quickly.
That's a beautiful shot. That might go for four. Fantastic. There, that's exquisite shot.
They need a few more like this. Definitely got to go looking for it now. This was up in the slot.
Watching the ball right onto the bat there. Good pitches. Oh, yes. He fiddled around with it, but boy, gee, did he have control over it, Douche? Did he have control over it?
I tell you what, it came out of the bat sweetly. This was very well timed. But straight down his throat. So a wicket for Tassara. Gunaratne goes for 16. It's 86 for 6.
Need 65 from 38 balls, but they've only got four wickets left. New batsman is Dupree. Letting balls go at this time. Well, big question for me. Did he have control over the ball? Let's have a look at it here. He's hit it. Caught it. All right, he threw it up. I said, guys, dropped it. Well, look, I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Well, for one, there reason why I said that, I remember a certain fieldsman at Headingley dropped one like that. Anyway, 14 overs gone, 87 for 6. The Rudras need 10.6 runs and over to win this game here. They've only got 4 wickets in hand, and really it's down to Kapagadera, 21 for 22. Only one boundary is hit. He needs to target this guy here, I believe. He needs to go with Harathia. He's got 1 for 13 off 3. Just a miserly touch from him tonight. Been another good performance from him. He rarely bowls a bad spell. He's right on the money there. Oh, he's off and running here. A good time, and it's 11 o'clock handy time here in Sri Lanka. Well, they're well aware that they're going to attack soon, so they've taken a slip out. Whip through mid wicket for one, square leg. Bowler, left-arm orthodox, probably the best bowlers I've faced in my time. Left-arm orthodox would be Fish Bish and Betty in the nets once. I thought he was obviously nothing short of outstanding. Maninder Singh is up there as one of the best left-armers I saw when he was bowling well in India. Only one there. Certainly not. I didn't face Derek Underwood. Test there, 154, 10 wicket all at 110 for fantastic numbers. I don't know who yours was, Jeff.
I reckon it would be, well, left arm spinners, I would go with Maninder as well. When he was on top of his game, he was an extremely good bowler.
Good lad too. Enjoy his company when I get a chance to see him. Just want to get the field right here. They're bowling at more middle and leg now. Here's the Karen ball. This will be the leg side wide.
We're going to get some top-up spinners too, like Tommel.
Yeah, bold off-spin Tommel. Particularly now. He'll get that away for... Looking for two. Oh, they're running now. Now, will he get a straight one? Is he out? No, he makes it easy. Still don't know why these batsmen run so far away from the pitch.
Well, they're running hard, but... this isn't going to be enough. They keep getting the singles and it's not really making too much of an impression on what they really need.
They need two sixes to get it back in the game. As far as I'm concerned, end of the over, it's 95 for 6. there's the comparisons at the moment. Basnahira 103 for 3 at this stage, but the Rudras 95 for 6 here. So they need, the Rudras need 56 from 30 balls. They need at least 2 or 3 sixes, well, 2 sixes to get back into this game. And I dare say it'll have to be Fidera will be the major guy to actually get those. Jeffrey Dujon's left us. Jeffrey Thompson's hopped in for it, taking his seat.
I'm back, Dino, for the last session of the second game of, well, this is our last little couple of games at Kandy, isn't it? We're off to Colombo.
Jay Ratner just working his bowling out. Yeah, we've had an absolute fun time here in Kandy. Met so many good friends, and we really do appreciate the hospitality and friendships they've given us while we've been here. We'll, no doubt we'll be back again, and it's a beautiful part of the world.
How would you know? You've been playing golf every minute you've had off.
And getting my backside smacked that as well by the locals with their so-called handicaps. But anyway, that's another thing. Talking about handicaps, Rudras have got one, 56 from 30 balls. Oh, he didn't quite get it off the toe of the bat.
Yeah, Dupre was trying to launch that one down the ground. It was probably there, it was wide to hit, but it hit the end of the queue. It went nowhere. Oh, well, it did go somewhere, just for one.
Yeah, this pitch is really slowing up now. It's into its fourth day, fourth night. Slower ball, changing it up. I get another one. Pretty hard to line it up. Not too much dew, I've noticed. I notice they're not really worried about the dew. They're not wiping the ball at all, so I was quite surprised when I asked Dilshan when he won the toss, elected to bat. I said, what about the dew? And he said, well, is there any? Well, there was in the past couple of nights, but not tonight. Oh, he's hit that well. Just wide. Oh, and it's skated away. And fantastic piece of work down there to save two. And look at that for fielding. Brilliant fielding.
Hey, that's as good as it gets. This one does skid off the turf. Watch this bounce and watch this catch. Well, it's not a catch, but watch him pull it in. And then the throw, if that's not good enough, the throw goes to the far end straight over the stumps.
Yeah, good work. Slower ball down the ground. Be looking for two. Boundary riders working really well there. That brings up the 100 for the Rudras.
Yeah, they just got to keep it going, Dino, like you say. A couple of clean hits would maybe give them a ray of sunshine.
Two sixes, two fours. We'll get them back right into this game if they can do that over the next 10 balls. Well, there's four of them. One bounce. Good shot. Over extra cover, one of the hardest shots in the game to play. Need a bit more of that, please.
Yeah, that's right. He's giving him a little bit of room. And he's hammered this. It wouldn't be too far away from a six, this shot. He's got that right in the screws.
Free flow of the bat. Slow ball, and they just get one. So that completes the over. 10 runs from it. It's 105 for 6. And it looks like it's the strategic timeout. It was last night's game, Jay. One of the 96 night outs. Geez, was one of the highlights of the Sri Lankan Premier League. They won last night to go to top of the table, and what a cameo knock it was. This is brilliant batting for one of the best players in the world.
Yeah, this will be a hard one to top. This was the last evening, as Dino said. He found it difficult to start with, but when you watch those pitches, you sort of wonder where they come from, because after a couple of overs, he got his cider in, and away he went. There he is with a 116, helped with that innings last night. But Cameron Akbal, he's been the star so far, and there's a few other good efforts out there. But Wayambo United have three in that top list, and that's why they're on top of our list, the leading team so far.
There's the skipper. He'd be pretty happy the way his charges are played tonight. They need to win this game to have any chance of making the finals. Now Mendes comes on. His third over. On the ground for one. Will they target this fella? They've got the short boundary on the leg side. Look for the slog sweep or the shot down the ground. That's where they've got to go.
Well, he's been a little expensive in comparison to the others. Pitch is a little slow. He's either got to bowl it slower and loopier to me, or just push it through a little more. One of the two, one of the options, or just mix it up with both. He's been a little short in those first two overs he bowled. He was getting pulled.
This over is just a slight concern for them, I reckon, for Dilshan, because if he does get hit for a 6 and a 4 in this over, or hits 15-16 off, let me tell you, this game's going to go to the wire. And the game's in a precarious little situation at the moment.
Well, Dupree's got to go for him.
Good fielding, keeping low.
One of them's got to have a go at a couple of boundaries, that's for sure, Dina. No use dying wondering.
Two runs a ball is required now to win this match. Will Capicadera take him on? Not out, no run. Or now they're under a little bit of pressure here. Now this ball here will have a lot of pressure on it. Will he go for the big 6 or 4? They just need a couple of sixes and they're right in this game for me. In there, there's one of them. Great shot, just short of a length. And just didn't he jump on it?
That's a pretty good hit off the back foot. Hard shot to play, especially against the spinner. Not sure what it's going to do, how much bounce it's going to get. And that screen there, it just landed up level with that. Just too short. This is where he's hurt this guy when he's bowled. He's pulled him down too much. And that one, off the back foot, is a big hit.
Need another one. Oh, good piece of fielding again. Right, now the guy runs off the over. I dare say he has to just go for the throat here. He's trying to keep it full. If he drops it a bit shorter, he'll go. Oh, well bowled, son. That's really good bowling. Excellent bowling. 9 runs from it. That's 114 for 6. Basnahira, if they win this game here, they'll go to fourth on the table, and as you probably just reminded me, they'll go to Colombo as well, because that's their next match. Uthura have got no chance of getting in the finals. So, the Rudras need 37 from 18 balls, as again, they only need a 6 and a 4 somewhere, and they're right in this game. Let me tell you, 6 and 2 fours. So, who can they target? Capicadera, 37 for 32. He's got a 6 and 2 fours himself. Now he's going to take on Prasad, who's got 1 for 17 off 2. Good steady bowler. And he likes to mention a few things to batsmen when he knocks them over.
He was a little cheeky earlier on, wasn't he, Prasad? He bowled a couple of half volleys that got spanked, and then he got a wicket and had a few things to say.
Oh, he's got that. He might get just one good piece of field. They go up for two. Good running. Good running indeed. A direct hit might have been out too.
I'll tell you what, you want to be a good shot for a direct hit from out there. You'd be filthy if you got run out with a direct hit from the fence. Side on. It was good running, but I had to push it. They're not really running that hard either, Dan.
How close did he get, Tomo? Let's have a look. Oh, he would have been out. Direct hit would have been out. So, Capicadera is lining up Prasad. Can he get him for a six or a four somewhere? He might get two. No, he'll only get one. Gee, he's working well down out there. Dimitar really working well.
Yeah, he's doing a bit of work, isn't he? He's getting his money tonight.
So, the equation, 34 from 16 balls, and this is how all the guys work it out around the world. If they can get a couple of sixes and a four, of course, you do the math at 16 off that, that means they'll get 18 off 13 balls. So that's quite easily got. You've got who's going to hit the six and the two fours. That's the key. Dupree. And is that one of them? That's four. Right, so now all of a sudden the equation gets a little bit tougher now. And let me tell you, Basnahira are feeling it right now.
Yeah, they're not totally confident out there. It was a full toss. And bang, he still put it away. Good shot atop the bottom of the queue. I wonder what the bowler's going to bowl now for Sutton. He'll be a bit nervous. He gives the impression he's cheeky and cocky and all that, but deep down I think he's really butterflies.
Well, I think he's just giving too much width, and now his defensive lines now for Prasad has to be full at leg stump now for me. And hopefully Dupree might be thinking, can he just give a little lap around the corner? If he drops it just short of the length, he might go as well. They need another six and a four. Oh, he's got one at least. Hit that off the toe.
Yeah, it's a good delivery, that one. He's given a good reply to the boundary. Cramped it. All he could get was one. And that's not enough.
Two more balls in this over. So 14 balls to go. They need 29. So if they can get a six and a four here somewhere. They need to get a six and a four in the next six balls for me if they've got any chance of winning this game. Capicadero's got 40. And he's hit it. Has he got enough? Has he got enough? Yes, he has. There's your six. Good batting.
Well, he's listening. He struck this well. He's down the pitch, and that was always six from the moment he hit it. Very good shot. There's a man down there, but he's got all the time in the world to hit through that. That was just not a good delivery. He's come at him, he's dropped it shorter, and all he did was give him a half volley.
Oh, he didn't get it either. See the bat just shimmy a little bit in his hand. Now will he bowl a slower ball here? I doubt. He's got to bowl a full at leg stump. I need another four. I need another four. Punched it out there for one. That was pretty good defensive bowling just there. So 15 runs from that over. We've got a game on here, folks. Don't go away. 129 for six. The Rudras need 22 from 12 balls. Game on, folks. We have a game on. Capicadera 47 from 36 balls. Dupree has played very well, 16 from 12. Now he's two best bowlers. He saved up here, Dilshan, to bowl the last two overs.
There he is, the skipper, just working it around because they only need 22 from 12 balls here. So this game is going to go into the last over no matter what. So who we've got on?
Thesara. That is Dino Thalanthas Thesara. And the comparison at this time is exactly, well, almost, it's just one run in it. And the comparative scores at 18 overs.
Oh, magnificent inside at that six. What a shot. The shot of the tournament for me. The shot of the tournament over cover, not extra cover, over cover. And now 16 from 11. It's a Donald from here.
Well, and the reason that's a good shot is because of the situation. 100 metres, six. The 100th, six of the tournament, sorry. I'm thinking he hit 100 metres. I know he hit it well, but not that well. But that is a hard shot to play, and especially in this situation, and he just made it look so easy.
Well, that's how they whittle it down. You've got to attack teams on the 16th and 17th over. 16 from 11 balls. Around the wicket now. Down the ground, six more. How good a batting is that? Oh, that's his 50. Well, he's got 50 of the previous one. He's 59 for 38 balls. Kappa Gadara, one magnificent batting.
Well, two in a row. Have a go at this. This is as good a shot as you're going to see. That one clipped off the toes. And he's hit that well. Oh, the pitch has changed a little and the skipper a bit nervous.
Well, if they lose this game, they're out of it. Sives it away for one. Basnahira lose this game, they're gone. They will not make the finals and he knows it. They're still in it. They need 9 from 9 balls, but they need to get a couple of wickets here, a couple of dot balls. So he needs to take a gamble somewhere. If he has the fieldsman on the inner ring, well, they're going to get singles all the time. So he's got to back himself and get these guys in, the mid wicket, the cover.
This has got to be leg stump Yorker if he's had any chance of no run.
Just one more. It's good batting. Good batting. Just keep getting bat on ball. Geez, the Rudras have done well here. They've just got the momentum back on their side. Now they've got to finish it. 8 from 8 balls. Where you got to believe, there's Tommy Moody. Absolutely stoked the way his team's played here. They've had 4 losses in a row. Now he's bowling to over the wicket now to Kappa Gadara. Good bowling, good defensive bowling, good lines. Only one. 7 from 7.
Yes, still anybody's game.
Do you take a risk on this ball here and really try to mow it? Just have a big hit here?
Well, he's big enough to hit it. The only way he can mow it is if he gives him the right delivery, so it depends. If it's loose, it'll go.
Back yourself, hit it. And he did, and he did, and he got it for 4. He's got it for 4. Oh, what a big over that was there for the Rudras. 19 runs from it, 148 for 6. Need 3 from 6 balls, and there's a lot of people watching this thing. How the hell did they get there? Well, they worked it out beautifully. They really did. 16th and 17th overs, they really attacked and went hard, pinpointed certain bowlers. But Kappa Gadara, 61 from 40. The coach is a lot happier now. He's not too happy, let me tell you, because if they lose this match, they're gone. So all of a sudden right now, all the fieldsmen in the inner ring trying to save a single. Air high! There's a fieldsman there! Catch it! Catch it!
He couldn't. It's safe and they'll get two. It's even Steven now here at Pallekele.
Well, that was in the air for an eternity, that one. But he's hit it where nobody was. The mid-off was up and he chipped it over the top. At first I thought he hit it for six. Well, that was their last chance. Well, isn't this a turnaround?
It is, because what happens here, Basnahira lose now, only five, now there's five to make the finals.
There it is, finished it off with class and style. Well played, you two. 70-run partnership of 34 balls. Capagandera, 69 from 42. Dupree, 21 from 14. And disappointments all around for Basnahira, but, oh, gee, what a great way they finished that game off. Well done to the Rudras. They haven't had a win yet, and they got one back tonight.
Isn't it surprising how you can get there, just with a bit of faith there, but they really needed somebody to stand up, and Capagandera, 69 from 42, two fours, five sixes he hit in that final onslaught there. And Dupree at the other end, he needed somebody to stay with him. He was pretty good with his 22 from 14. But boy, I would have bet my house on this one going the other way half an hour ago. And it's been all turned around there. Well, they're pretty happy with themselves. But Basnahira, they'll be shattered. They'll wonder how they lost that one. Thought they had it in the bag and it just escaped. The string came undone and out they flew.
Well, let's just have a look at the batting cut here, the Rudras. They just, it's just a fantastic chase. Look, no one really got off to a start. Farrakh on 26. But it all comes down to the last two guys. Capagandera, 69 for 42. Dupree, 21 for 14. Six extras. Good discipline effort there with the ball with Basnahira. But they got those with four balls to spare. Who would have thought?
Well, the bowling, it was looking good for a long time there. So Ratna there, none for 31, copped a little bit of stick. Two wickets to Thissara for 40, and they just upped the ante at the end. It was pretty good till the last few overs. That's where they lost it.
Well, let's have a look at the match summary here. Basnahira, they won the toss, elected to bat, 150 for 6. Good knock by Rosso with 44. Borgas got 28, but some beautiful, well, excellent bowling, really, from Dupree, 1 for 17. And they followed up with Capagandera with 69 not out and Dupree with 21 not out. And not, apart from Mamadoula bowled two overs, 1 for 9. A lot of them got a bit of a spanking there in the end. Let's have a little look at Capagandera's little lock of 50. What about this for a flurry?
It was good, wasn't it? This is, well, that was off the back foot. That was a huge hit. This one down the ground. He hit five sixes in all. And that one there, Dean Jones reckons, is a good shot. And then immediately after that, he hit that six over mid-wicket. And then he wasn't still finished then. And that brought up the win. Superb innings from him. Five sixes off his 42 balls and two fours.
Well, let's have a look at the points table. Really, they've gone. Really, they've only got another game to go. Basnahira, Uthura, and they will not make it because you'll need to have at least 6 points to get through. So the last spot is a fight, I would dare say, between Kandarana and Aruna Royals, with Wayamba easily on top. Don't go away. Straight after the break, we've got the match presentation.
Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League. Mahindra, Sri Lanka Premier League.
A huge ball over here. Uthura Rudras have won this match here in Kandy, and what a match it was. Well, let's go down to the Mahindra man of the match. Roshan's taking proceedings.
A very good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen, and yes, welcome to the Mahindra Man of the Match presentation party. Well, this was just after an absolutely magnificent game between Uthura Rudras and Basnahira Cricket Dundees. Let me start off by introducing our distinguished panel here. Mr. Sunil Fernando, the provincial coach of Central Province, who also happens to be Muthaiah Muralidharan, Sri Lanka's Spin Wizards first coach. Mr. Shankar Maniwanan, Treasurer, Noorelia District Cricket Association. Mr. Kumar Kanagaratnam, General Manager, Ideal Motors Private Limited. He will be awarding the Mahindra Man of the Match Award. Rimpi Chamola, co-owner of Rudra Sports. And of course, Sherin Hussain of Basnahira Cricket Dundee. But let me start off by inviting the losing captain, Tilakratna Dilshan, to have a few words with us. You don't seem to be all right, but you very nearly had the game in the bag.
Yeah, I think he's really disappointed again. We didn't well today's. We didn't we start well as a bowling unit, but 18th and 19th over, we really bad. We bowled really bad. That 2 overs took gave from the.
I don't want to ask you too many questions. Just one question. You think you had enough runs on the board?
I think. Sorry, I think it's enough runs on the board. 150 is good total. I think. We didn't bowl well. One stage 84-6 is a good, we have done very really well, but last few overs we didn't bowl well.
Well, get well soon and play well in the next game.
Thank you very much.
Well, Tilakratna Dilshan, the losing captain of the Basnahira Dundee. Now, may I invite the beaming Jehan Mubarak, the winning captain of Uthura Rudras. You finally made it, Jehan. Well done. You can't hide your delight, can you?
We finally got there. Some jitters towards the middle of the innings, but it's a fantastic feeling just to get the win under your belt. The guys have worked very hard towards this, and there's been a lot of back and forth things going on, but we got there in the end.
I really thought that you might be the losing captain again.
It looked like that way somewhere after the sixth over innings. We got ourselves into a real big mess, losing 4 wickets, but I thought Chamara played a fantastic innings, paced himself very, very well, and just when it was needed, hit the boundaries as well. That's one of the best innings I've seen.
Yeah, no doubt. And looking at your side, I think you got the right balance. What really went wrong with the team? Why haven't you done well in this tournament so far?
Well, as I said, we've made mistakes at crucial times. Even today, early on, we made a few mistakes. And that has cost us. And in 2020 cricket, you can't be chasing the game. You make a mistake, you end up paying for it.
Very well done, Jehan. Enjoy the next game.
Thank you, Roshan.
Well, Jehan Mubarak, the winning captain, ladies and gentlemen, of Uthura Rudras. And now it's my privilege to invite the man of the match, Chamara Kapugedra, who will first accept his award from Kumar Kanagaratnam, the general manager, Ideal Motors. And then he will step forward and have a word with me. Well done, Kapu. I'm sure you must be very, very proud with that knock.
Yeah, I am, and it's great to get a win under our team. It's when we've been losing a few matches, and it's not good to lose, so it feels really good to win a game, and you can be proud of it.
Tell me your feeling when Jehan Mubarak was run out and the side was down and out. What were you thinking?
Well, those things happen in cricket, so I thought to myself that if I need to be there in the end, then I can finish this thing off. So that's what I did. Came off well.
Any particular point you felt that you could win the game?
Well, obviously it's a little bit hard to hit against spin, so I knew that they had to bring on pace in the end, so that's what I was waiting for. So it came off well and plan worked.
Very well done, Kapu. We're very proud. Well played.
Thank you very much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Chamara Kapugedra, the man of the match, and that's it from the presentation area.
Thanks very much, Roshan. Great job down there. Fantastic knock it was from Kapugedra. And we got Colombo coming up. Wyambo United versus Kandarata Warriors. That's going to be a brilliant game, that one. That starts at 8 o'clock on Friday. So the big wins there to Uva next and Uthura Rudras. From now on, from leaving Kandy, so goodbye and see you in Colombo.